Following is a presentation of WNWS Sports.
News Talk 101.5 and the High School Game of the Week. Now, the High School Game of the Week on News Talk 101.5.
Good evening and welcome to this beautiful campus, University School of Jackson. Tonight we've got USJ hosting Sacred Heart in a double-dip basketball game, a region matchup, and a big crowd on hand here on a busy night. On the USA campus is over on the football field. They're hosting the West Tennessee High School Football All-Star Game, made up of seniors all across West Tennessee. That's presented by Sports Plus Rehab Centers. My name's Dan Reeves, along with Will Walker. Hey, Will, how you doing?
I'm doing great, man. How about you?
Tremendous to see you, my friend. And you're a student over at Sacred Heart, and you know how big this game is tonight between these two teams. They haven't been around that long, Sacred Heart, but still a rivalry has developed already. And these two teams in the same region will battle tonight. It's a very important game.
Sacred Heart's really, this is their game that they look forward to all season. And you can just tell the atmosphere in the school. It's crazy. And everybody gets so excited for this game. And I'm excited to see how it plays out.
USJ and Sacred Heart really is separated by, not even a block, maybe a house between the two schools. Sacred Heart comes in tonight against this established USA Lady Bruin program. Tony Schutz is legendary. And, well, you know this, he's well-dressed. He's the best-dressed coach in West Tennessee. That's Tony Schutz. The guy's been there. He's done that. He has everything but a state championship. But this Sacred Heart ball club, compare them record-wise as they come into tonight's game.
Right now, the Lady Knights are 2-3 overall record, but they are 1-0, coming off a huge district win against FACS Tuesday night. The Lady Knights are going to look to ride this momentum in to maybe get their second district win.
So it's USJ and it's Sacred Heart coming up here in just a few minutes. It's loud in here. It's the introduction of the USJ Lady Bruins. They turn the lights down. They turn the spotlight on. They make a big deal out of it. And it excites the student base and the fans alike. And it excites Paul Schulze. He's running things for us on the WNWS.com side with Worthy Road Studios. As we get sent for some basketball, the lights are up. And here we go. Dan Reeves and Will Walker with you. Here on our digital TV network, USJ and Sacred Heart. The girls get it on first. These two teams, when you look at USJ, what they've done so far this year, with Tony Schutz, they played a very tough schedule. Tonight at halftime, they're going to retire one of the greatest Lady Bruins of all time. They're going to retire her number tonight at halftime as Anna Jones is here. Sacred Heart controls the tips. We'll get you the starters here in just a moment. Here's Sacred Heart, a wide open three that nearly knocked the backboard over. Rebound USJ. Here the Lady Bruins come off and running it in front court on the left wing. Now they swing it right wing in the corner. An open look at a three. Yes, sir. Speaking of Anna Jones, that's her little sister. Knocking down that tray from downtown. It's Olivia Jones, Will.
I mean, that's a great way to start off the game. Open three, and it gets things rolling for the Lady Bruins.
Can't give her an open look, as she'll make you pay. Here's an open look for Sacred Heart from downtown. Yes, from the corner for three. It's Caitlin Hill, the freshman.
I mean, Sacred Heart right there punches right back. Trey and trades blows.
Emily Jones, three. That went around the rim and came out. Rebound, Sacred Heart. For USJ on the floor, the starters, Emily Jones. And, well, not Anna. She's not playing. Out of bounds, it'll stay with Sacred Heart. Sophie Stallings, a senior for this USJ team. Emily Jones. Now they go corner, another three. No, hit the front of the iron. Crawled over the side, rebound. Emily Jones, hand to Olivia. Now to front court, Stallings, top of the key they go. Now it's Emily Jones, right wing. Cross court pass, Stallings on the left wing. Perimeter basketball for USJ. Here's Emily, or make it Olivia, out on the left wing. Picked up a screen, couldn't get open. Now they work it in the corner, a three's on its way. Too strong, back iron, rebound USJ. The putback, no, but a foul will send Callie Cosgro, a senior for the Lady Bruins, to the foul line to shoot two. Now for USJ, on the floor, Emily Jones, Sarah Beth Rouse, Callie Cosgro, her first free throw won't go, Sophie Stallings, Callie Cosgro on the floor for the Lady Bruins. Coached by Tony Schutz, his Cosgro goes 1 of 2. Hey, Paul, can I get a little bit more volume, please? I'm a prima donna. Give me some more volume, Paul, in my ears, would you please? Here is Sacred Heart. Say, Will, it's a prima donna here. Sacred Heart in the front court on the move. It's 4-3. USJ with an early lead, 6-10 left. We're in the first quarter still. Olivia Jones off and running in the front court. In the lane, off the glass, yes! Olivia Jones, well, not only can she knock down from long distance, she plays very good defensively.
Yeah, that's a great job running in transition, getting out in front of the defense, and his good defense leads to easy offense.
Here's Sacred Heart down by three. 5:44 left, a foul on USJ on the floor. 5:43 left in the first quarter, 6-3 advantage USJ. Not a very deep team for Sacred Steel. Cosgro, USJ in the lane, off the glass, yes sir. It's 8-3, Lady Bruins, a 4-0 run with 5:36 left. Here in the first quarter, the Lady Bruins have opened up a 5-point advantage, Will. Here's Sacred Heart in the front court, trying to work it down low. The pass is too tall and out of bounds, turnover. Ball goes back to USJ. Charles Dotson, the head coach for the Lady Knights, assisted by Ann, is it Kale? Ann Kale, isn't it, Will?
Yes, sir.
And John Barlow. The Sacred Heart Knights. Here's Cosgro, double team. They strip it away. Nice defensive play by Emily Gill. And now it's a tie-up. Possession arrow will give it right back to the Lady Bruins. Good defense here early, Will.
Yeah, right now, Sacred Heart's struggling a lot to break the press, and the pressure's causing a lot of turnovers, which is ending in USJ having easy layups on the fast break.
Here's USJ. Out top of the key, it's Emily Jones. Now Stallings has it, working right wing. On the floor for Sacred Heart, Jasmine Blankenship, Caitlin Gill, Grace Creasy, a three. Yes, that's Emily Jones from downtown, and the Lady Bruins have opened up an 11-3 lead with 4:42 left in the first quarter. Here's Sacred Heart down low off the glass. Yes, beautiful entry pass, and Bree Marks, the senior, deposits it for two. Here's Emily Jones, now top of the key, they swing at right corner, Sophie Stallings. 4:25 left in the opening quarter. Cosgro dumps it down low off the glass. You know it won't go. It hung on the rim and fell off. Great look down low for Claire Lewis. It'll go out of bounds and stay with USJ.
And I mean, you see on that last possession, Sacred Heart's able to break the press and get it down low. They're going to need more opportunities like that if they're going to push back into this game.
And a foul on Sacred Heart. 4 minutes and 44 seconds left in the opening quarter. 11-5. The Lady Bruins with a lead. Will, your thoughts so far on this game?
I like USA coming out, pressing, playing aggressive defense, and right now it's working out in their favor, giving them many open opportunities on the fast break.
Lewis missed her first free throw. Flair goes 1 of 2 from the foul line. And the Lady Bruins take a 12-5 lead. 4 minutes and 11 seconds remaining. Quarter number one. Here's Sacred Heart. Lost the ball. Jones takes it ahead. Stallings, front court, left wing. Here's Sophie. Cut off there by the defense. She'll hand it over to Emily Jones. Out near the timeline. Now working over right wing. Here's Stallings in the corner on the right side. Perimeter basketball. Now Olivia Jones left wing. She'll work the baseline. Dribble drive. Yes, off the glass. Working at baseline. A beautiful dribble drive by Olivia Jones for two.
And that was just an amazing layup. Able to fight through contact and lay it in, making it look easy.
She's a great athlete, and she will.
Yeah, it's extremely impressive.
Here is Sacred Heart. Got it trapped over the corner. Needs some help. Gill does. It's slapped out of bounds. It'll stay with Sacred Heart as USJ, Claire Lewis, and Sophie Stallings will set into the game for the Lady Bruins. Sarah Beth Brouse and Julie Wagner back into the game. Wagner, a sophomore. Some high down low to foul on USJ on the floor. For USJ team fouls, that's their second, the first on Sarah Beth Brouse. For Sacred Heart, they have two team fouls. Here's Sacred Heart, wide open look at a three. No, it's off the glass. Karam's outside, ran down by USJ's Brouse. Here she comes, front court, right wing. It's Olivia Jones down low. Here's Wagner, spinning, twisting, shooting, scoring. That's Julie Wagner down low. She's 6 foot or so. Will and Wagner, only a sophomore, with some height, long arms down low. She used that height to spin off the defense and lay it off the glass.
Yeah, no, she found a mismatch right there, and it results in just an easy point for USJ.
You know, I forget we're doing TV only tonight. Don't need so much description for me, Will. Will said, geez, this guy talks a lot. Typically, we're on the radio and on digital TV. Steal, Olivia Jones, over to Anna. Here she comes, down low, it's Wagner, yes. Timeout, Sacred Heart. Holy moly. 18-5. USJ with 2.5 minutes left. We're in quarter number one, 18-5. The Lady Bruins have opened this game up. And it's presented by Outback Steakhouse in Jackson. Outback Steakhouse in Jackson has been voted the number one Outback Steakhouse in the state of Tennessee. And they judge that based off of cleanliness, food quality, customer service. Outback Steakhouse in Jackson. No rules, just right. Open Monday through Friday at 4 p.m. And it's Saturday and Sunday. They open up at 11 a.m. Outback Steakhouse in Jackson. If you've not downloaded that Outback Steakhouse app, do that as soon as possible. 2:22 left in the first quarter. It's 18-5, the Lady Bruins with the advantage and a foul on USJ. That's going to be Brouse's second, team third. Dan Reeves along with Will Walker, son of Chuck and Christy Walker. You know, Will, is looking at Olivia Jones and the move she was making down there. There's a foul on Olivia. She's your age, a sophomore.
Yes, sir.
Do you know Olivia?
No, sir, I don't know her personally.
Does she know who you are?
I have no clue.
I love you, Will. I've known Will since he was like about 5 years old.
No, I mean, it's been a really long time. Oh, longer than I remember.
Man, Steele, here's USJ. Will said it's longer, and he wants to remember. Here's Brouse, three. Yes, yeah, Beth Brouse from downtown. Nothing but the bottom of the sack, and the Lady Bruins have opened up a 21-5 lead.
I mean, right now, USJ is just capitalizing on every Sacred Heart mistake, and it's really showing on the scoreboard.
It is 21-5, and another turnover, Will, as Sacred Heart throws it away. This game is presented in part by the Hughes Eye Group. Dr. Matt Hughes, Dr. Casey Davis, and we got a timeout here. Let's see. USJ calls a timeout. We'll keep it right here. It's a half. But a minute 44 remaining in the opening quarter, 21-5. It's advantage, Lady Bruins. The Hughes Eye Group, Dr. Matt Hughes, Dr. Casey Davis, Chief LASIK Surgeon, Dr. David Underwood, Elizabeth Nordvik, Dr. Nordvik, Dr. James Linder, and Dr. Andrew Krause. Cataract, LASIK, retina, glaucoma, oculoplastics, health and cosmetics, all. It's the Hughes Eye Group. 112 Stonebridge, Jackson, the best in medical and surgical eye care. The Hughes, that's HughesEye.com. Here's USJ. Emily Jones, three. Nope. Hit the front of the iron, crawled over the side of the rim. Rebound, Brouse, USJ. Here's Stallings. Now Emily Jones, dribble drive. She'll stop at the elbow and shoot and miss, but she's fouled. And, well, that will send Emily Jones back to the foul line.
I mean, you just watch her in warm-ups. I think she made eight in a row that I counted. She seems very consistent from the line, and it's probably not the person you want to put up there.
No, she's a great player. Free throw, yes. This game's also presented by Best One Tire and Service of Jackson, making your family safe with our family of tires and services. Also presented by Southeastern Termite Pest Control and Service Company. That is what keeps Will food on the table. Will said, go termites. Yes, termites. Get that free home inspection, 660-1052, 660-1052. Foul on U.S. Shane. It's going to be team foul number four. Team foul number four. On the Lady Bruins, it's on the floor. A minute 14 left in the first quarter, 23-5 USJ. That's Stallings, foul number one. Brown steal, USJ. Here's a 1-on-2 in the paint off the glass, yes. Turnovers right now, Will, killing Sacred Heart, eliminating any chance for this team to be in the game.
I mean, USJ's running the break very well. Good vision by all the guards, making all the right passes and just capitalizing on every single mistake.
That's what they're doing. Slapped out of bounds. It'll stay with the Sacred Heart. Also, this game presented by King Jewelers, the best selection of jewelry, best available prices. Oh, it's rejected by Wagner. Three, swatted. That looked like what I do in the driveway when Seabass tries to drive. Swatted out, steal. Stallings in the paint, off the glass, yes, and a foul. A chance at a three-point play the old-fashioned way. Sophie Stallings with a steal, and she will deposit that stolen merchandise for 2 points. 27-5 with 39 seconds left in the first half. And Will, it was a three-point game 5 minutes ago, seemed like.
You know, the USJ came out not pressing, and then it was, I believe it came out 3-5, and as soon as that happened, they haven't scored since. They started pressing. It's caused a lot of problems for the Sacred Heart offense, and they're just not able to get the ball all the way up the court, not able to work it down low, which is what their core offense is getting it down to Bree Marks, and they just haven't been able to do that. So they're struggling a lot right now on offense.
That was Wagner down low, traveling to get the ball back to Sacred Heart. USJ had rebounded. The Stallings missed free throw and were fouled. Bruins slap it out of bounds. It'll stay with Sacred Heart. Will's got an interview coming up at halftime with the head basketball coach of the Sacred Heart boys team, Nicholas Beauregard. Sacred Heart a three. No, that one had some moon dust on it. Rebound Sacred Heart, put back, no. Wagner wipes the glass clean. Over to Brouse, here come the Lady Bruins in the front court. Over in the right corner, that's Molly Strong. Now down low, Claire Lewis had it ripped away as the quarter ends. It's all Lady Bruins after one quarter. USJ 27, Sacred Heart 5. We're back in 30 seconds on WNWS.com.
It's going down this Thursday at the Blacksmith Bar and Grill. Thursday nights during football season, the cheap seats will be live at the Blacksmith for Thursday Night Throwdown. Football fans will have cornhole, ping pong, and we'll be giving away Titans tickets to some lucky winner, courtesy of MasterFit Medical. Located at 216 North Shannon Street, across from the Farmer's Market. Try the Johnny Cakes or Fried Green Tomatoes or the Molten Burger. Maybe it's the Hot Chicken Sandwich or the Blackened Shrimp. Thursday night's new home for football is the Blacksmith Bar and Grill. Downtown Jackson, across from the Farmer's Market.
And we move on to the second quarter here in, Chuck, get us a cup of coffee and a shrimp dinner. What do you want?
I'm on a 14-ounce ribeye. That sounds great right now.
There you go, Will. We move on to the second quarter. Dan Reeves, Will Walker with you. Will is starting what I feel like is going to be a long, successful career in broadcasting and in telecasting. Pleasure to have you here tonight, Will. I'll tell you that.
It's... Pleasure for letting me come. It's an awesome experience to be able to do this.
Turnover. USJ turned it over. The Sacred Heart gives it right back. Paul Schulze, Worthy Road Studios, the best in the business. I mean, Paul was homeless when I found him. Look at him now. Making $7 an hour. Paul is great. The absolute best. Worthy Road Studios. Here's USJ up 27-5. Olivia Jones driving at baseline. She's cut off there. Good defense. She'll pull it back out. Top of the key. Now they work right side. Jones. Inside she goes. Cosgrove's fouled. She'll shoot two. Beautiful job, Olivia Jones. Will she lull the defense to sleep? Just kept dribbling it and kept dribbling it. They let down. Lost interest. She found Cosgrove down low, and she'll shoot two.
Yeah, without a shot clock, I mean, that was very good job by the Bruin offense. Being patient, letting the offense set itself up, and it sets up an easy bucket down low.
Coming back into the game, Emily Jones exiting as Molly Strong. USJ goes Sophie Stallings, Olivia Jones, Callie Cosgrove, who goes 1-2 to the foul line. Emily Jones has got a rebound. Claire Lewis. All on the floor for the Lady Bruins. Down low, Olivia Jones lost it, saved it in bounds. Here's Lewis, down low. Yes, sir. Spinning, twisting, shooting. Went to that offhand off the glass. 30-5, Will.
Yeah, I mean, that's another extremely athletic play by Olivia Jones. Giving the extra effort to save the ball and ends up for 2 points for the Bruins.
Yeah, it's a 30-5 game. It's still putting forth that sort of effort.
I mean, it's always awesome to see people going until the game's over. It doesn't matter. I like to think if you can't see the scoreboard, you want to have no clue who's winning the game. That's how you'll want to play, both teams.
Exactly. 30-5 USJ, 6.5 minutes remaining. We're in the second quarter. Stallings, three. Yes, sir. From downtown to Sophie Stallings. It's 33-5 USJ. USJ's on a, 28-2 run. Here's Sacred Heart. Trying to go down low, it's stolen away. Emily Jones, here's Emily. In the front court to her sister Olivia. Down low, beautifully done. Cosgrove, yes, off that back glass. Three passes, Will. They got inside off the glass, easy as pie. Timeout on the floor. Sacred Heart wants to talk about it. With 6 minutes left before halftime, we'll take the timeout with him. You're listening to USJ Bruin Basketball on WNWS.com.
Shop CarLock Nissan of Jackson on-site or online today. CarLock's new and used Nissan dealership in Jackson has stylish, competitively priced new options to explore. So don't put off your search for a Nissan any longer. CarLock's knowledgeable, experienced sales staff is committed to delivering a high quality of service that enables you to shop confidently. At CarLock Nissan of Jackson, we not only believe in supporting our customers, but in supporting the community we're proud to be a part of. We contribute to many causes and organizations, such as the Susan B. Komen Foundation and the Wounded Warrior Project. Slip behind the the wheel of a new Nissan Altima for an invigorating test drive or learn about the active safety features that come standard on the Rogue. Visit CarLock Nissan of Jackson today. We have an on-site finance department that will assist you with your bad credit, car loan needs, and a service team that will keep your purchase healthy for many years to come. Don't miss your chance to own a versatile new Nissan Versa today. Visit our dealership on Van Drive in Jackson today.
5:40 left, second quarter, 35-5. USJ clinging to a 30-point advantage. Dan Reeves, along with Will Walker. USJ long pass down the floor, yes, for two. Emily Jones is on fire, Will.
Yeah, right now, this USJ team is just riding all the momentum, and almost sucking the air out of Sacred Heart, and you can really start to tell this team's getting frustrated and not being able to score since the beginning of the first quarter.
Well, it makes it not so much fun to play basketball under these conditions. And I know they're trying to build a girls program. It's Sacred Heart. USJ, the established program, and right now it's out of hand. Stallings, three on his way. Yes, sir. I mean, that basket looks as big as the ocean to the Lady Bruins, and Will, for Sacred Heart, it looks as small as a thimble.
Well, I mean, it's always easier to make a basket right after the person before you makes it. They just have all the momentum and are riding it out.
And that's Olivia Jones with another steal and two more points off the glass. It's 42-5, Lady Bruins. Boy, oh boy, that is a kick by Olivia Jones. It'll stay with Sacred Heart. Wagner comes back into the game, and Claire Lewis will lead for USJ. USJ goes Sophie Stallings, Olivia Jones, Emily Jones, Julie Wagner, and Callie Cosgrove. Tony Schutz basketball team. This game presented by Premier Dental Center in Milan. Bells and in Jackson. PremDent.com. I've been a patient for 15 some odd years. Premier Dental Center. USJ with a steal. Emily Jones, dribble drive, baseline, stops, shoots, misses. Rebound, USJ, the putback, no, by Wagner, but she's fouled, she'll shoot two. Also by Home Medical Products. Home Medical Products, 877-660-0084. For Home Medical Products, hmpinc.net. Medical supplies and equipment when you need them at home, and it's your choice, patients. Don't let them fool you. You make that decision. We want you to choose the best. That's Home Medical Products. For oxygen, hospital beds, walkers, travel oxygen, power chair, car hitches, power wheelchairs, bedside commodes, lift chairs, rehab equipment. Here's Emily Jones. Yes, sir. Another steal, Will. Two more points.
Yeah, Sacred Heart struggling a lot right now with ball security, and they're not able to get anything going because every time they get up the court, the ball is being taken away. Pass is being intercepted. It's really slowing down the Sacred Heart offense.
CPAPs, BiPAPs, if you have sleep apnea, all this. Home Medical Products, HMPinc.net, USA again. Cosgrove will shoot two. She's fouled. Rehab equipment as well. 877-660-0084. Learn all you need to know at hmpinc.net. Great people right here in Jackson. Kevin Atkins, David Steele, Michael Pritchett, Chastity Eden. 45-5 now, USJ. Lady Bruins. Cosgrove misses her second. USJ rebound, Wagner goes back up, misses, her follow, yes. And Wagner with that big height advantage will just start to dominate on the block.
Yeah, with a below size Sacred Heart team, she's really standing out tonight, able to do a lot offensive and defensively. She's got multiple offensive rebounds, multiple second chance points, and is having a great night right now.
Sacred Heart just having a tough time getting a look. They haven't scored in this quarter. Dribble drive, and his shot is rejected, but a foul on Cosgrove. For the Lady Bruins this season, some early losses in this campaign. Lost to Greenfield, but you know, well, they played the state championship last year. Also lost to Needleton, Arkansas. One of two for the foul line. The Sacred Hearts. Grace Creasy. Lost to Summertown, a perennial powerhouse. USA can't convert. Lost by three to Dyersburg. But to beat Dyer County and Kell Academy, USA another steal in Sophie Stallings for 2 points.
I mean, this USJ offense, they're just making it look easy, making all the right passes, great vision by all the guards, able to find the open teammate going down the floor and setting up just easy baskets one after the next.
Timeouts. Well, just to stop in play, some substitutions as Cosgrove and Emily Jones will set. USA now on the floor. They go for Tony Schutz. Out of bounds to Sacred Heart. Julie Wagner, Olivia Jones, Sarah Beth Brouse, Sophie Stallings, Claire Lewis. For Tony Schutz, assisted by his wife, Stephanie Schutz, and Shelby Bailey. Steele, Stallings, one on two, in the paint, off the glass, yes! That was a rainbow for two.
And the high arc, able to get it up over the defense, and makes it look easy.
That was Anna Jones just came in. Maybe we could talk with her during the game. Did you see Anna, Chuck?
Yeah.
You see if she could come up a sec? Anna Jones going to have an honor here at halftime. Hey, Paul, is this Mike right here hot, big guy? Paul is watching the evening news. Another 2 points.
Number 20, USJ. 2 points.
That's her dad right there. See if he can get it. Yeah, that's Brandon. 2:05 left here in the first half. 53-6. USA, 2 minutes left before halftime. At halftime?
Yeah.
Well, I tell you, it's hard to get people these days. You'd think Will had more pull than Ed Steele. Here's Sacred Heart off the glass. No! Rebound Wagner.
And that's a missed opportunity right there by the Lady Knights to maybe get something going.
Minute 32 left. Is USA going to inbound the basketball? In the first half, Wagner had a shot partially blocked and taken by Sacred Heart. Got a night out in front. A little travel, but hey, why not? Travel channel called. And a double dribble on Sacred Heart. This game is also presented by MasterFit Medical Supply in Jackson. Chances are they supply your favorite doctor and dentist, medical supplies. 424-6383, MasterFit Medical Supply. By Young Hughes Insurance, foul inside, gonna send Claire Lewis to the foul line. Young Hughes Insurance, Cy Young of Young Hughes Insurance, he's a Cy Young Award winner. Will Walker will have an interview with Coach Boygard, the head coach for the Sacred Heart boys team at halftime, and also Anna Jones going to stop by. Lewis, free throw, yes. Young Hughes Insurance, call 695-7080. Also presented by Carlock Nissan of Jackson, 495 Van Drive. Brand new cars, trucks, and SUVs. Carlock Nissan of Jackson.com. Lewis hits them both. It's 55-6, Will, with 54 seconds left in the first half.
And right now, this young Sacred Heart team, they have four freshmen out on the court right now, and they're just struggling with the experience and the athleticism of the Lady Bruins right now, and it's really showing.
We also thank Vein and Vascular Center of Jackson, 395 Hospital Drive. Inside Wagner, double team. Wagner moves to her right, scores, and she's fouled. Only a sophomore, Will Wagner, just growing into that 6 foot frame of hers. She's only going to get better.
Yeah, no, I mean, as she continues to hone in her skills and really figure out how to use that size, she's going to be a big threat to every team that they go against.
Wagner, free throw, yes, a three-point play the old-fashioned way, and it's 58-6 Lady Bruins. The Sacred Hearts, top of the key. Sacred Heart trying to get an open look here. Blankenship down the corner, a three. No, hit the front of the iron. Caroms off of Stallings to Lewis. Back to Stallings. 10 seconds left at half. Here's Wagner inside. No. Nice defense and rebound by Marks. With 2 seconds, they're not going to get a shot off. That'll do it for the first half. It's all USJ 58-6 in the game presented by Tennessee Tractor. Success through innovation at Tennessee Tractor. By the Hickman Realty Group. Norm and Tammy Reed, Hickman Realty Group. Contact Norm and Tammy. For real estate here at West Tennessee. 616-6000. That's 616-6000 or 664-1006. The number one winning team in real estate. Norman, Tammy Reed. Also, we thank our friends over at the Old Town Spaghetti Store, Country Italian Grill. Old Town Spaghetti Store. Along with Garrett's Plumbing, Heating and Air Conditioning, 668-3339, 668-3339. For Garrett's Plumbing, Heating and Air Conditioning. By Rock and Dough Pizza, downtown Jackson and the Jackson Walk. By Sonic, America's Drive-In. Sonic of Jackson with 6 Jackson locations. Also, Hardy, Martin and Owens, attorneys at law right here in Jackson. Hardy, Martin and Owens, the heavy hitters, they tip the scale in your favor. Call 424-2151, 424-2151 for Hardy, Martin and Owens, attorneys at law right here in Jackson. Dan Reeves and Will Walker with you. When we come back, we'll chat with Anna Jones. She's going to receive an honor tonight at halftime. The Lady Bruins. We're back in 3 minutes.
There's several occasions in life when a man just needs to look good. And at Cambridge Limited Men's Clothier, we understand those moments.
Sally, will you go to the prom with me?
I would, but you look like a hobo.
Do you take this man to be your husband?
Not dressed like that, I won't.
Located on North Highland across from Toys R Us, Cambridge has the best tie selection in town, plus the best price. Size selection 36 short to 54 long and up. We have a tailor on staff and offer law enforcement specials on suits. Cambridge Limited Men's Clothier, North Highland, across from Toys R Us.
Do you know the temperature in your home? You should. If your system isn't operating properly, you can't stay cool in the steaming summer months that are to come. That's where Garrett Plumbing and Heating Company can help. With years of experience, Garrett services and repairs residential customers. They also provide estimates on new installations. Quality is job one at Garrett. Call 668-3339 and let Garrett Plumbing and Heating and Air go to work for you today.
At Home Medical Products, we provide patients with products to make sure you breathe, sleep, move, and live well. With items like nebulizers, travel oxygen, CPAPs, hospital beds, wheelchairs, scooters, lift chairs, commodes, and so much more. You have a choice when choosing Home Medical Companies. It's the patient's choice. Make the right choice. Locally owned and operated Home Medical Products. Call 877-660-0084 or find them online at hmpinc.net.
Don't worry, ooh, be happy. This is Tammy Reed telling you not to worry when it comes to real estate. Turn it over to the number one real estate team in West Tennessee. We will take all the worries out of your real estate experience. No gimmicks, no unkept promises, just happy clients. Call the Reed Nelson team, Hickman Realty Group, 664-1006. Don't worry, be happy.
Legal problems don't always arise Monday through Friday, 8 to 5. When you need an attorney, you need them now. This is Bradley Owens of Hardy Martin & Owens Law Firm. Add my cell number to your contacts. 234-2400. That's 234-2400. At Hardy Martin & Owens, we handle all types of legal problems, including personal injury, workers' compensation, divorce and family law, estates, and criminal defense. With offices in Jackson and Trenton, let Hardy Martin & Owens handle all your legal needs. 424-2151 or on my cell, 234-2400.
Tipping the scales in your favor.
Welcome to Hughes Eye. Our doctors and staff look forward to having you as a patient in our clinic. Our doctors and staff work together as a team to treat patients with outstanding care in a positive and friendly environment. We work closely with your local eye and medical doctors to provide care centered around you. Hughes Eye has offices throughout West Tennessee to better serve you. We offer cataract, LASIK, and glaucoma procedures, retina and oculoplastic specialties, as well as the treatment and management of many ocular diseases. We're proud to offer advanced technology to provide the most up-to-date treatment options for your eyes. Prior to your appointment, please take a moment to visit our website at hugheseye.com. There, you can submit new patient forms, find directions to our clinics, and learn more about your ocular condition.
The Hughes Eye Group, 112 Stonebridge, Jackson. The best in medical and surgical eye care. Call 731-664-1994 and visit hugheseye.com.
Back here at USJ with the Lady Bruins lead at halftime, 58-6. Couple of Jones girls having a big first half. Speaking of the Jones girls, I've got one of them with me, Anna Jones, who's now it's Middle Tennessee State University playing her basketball. She's back here tonight for a special occasion. Hey, Anna, how you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
Fantastic. How old are you now?
I'm 19. Love. I turned 20 on Monday.
On Monday?
Yes.
Happy birthday.
Thank you.
You know, Brandon Jones, your dad. What's your mom's name?
Renee,
for quiet out loud. Nana's here taking photos of you.
Yes.
Yeah. What's her name?
Jody.
Yes. Jody.
The whole fam's here today.
Now, who's this guy with the red hat on?
That's just a friend.
Okay. He's nobody?
He is somebody.
He's a nobody.
He's not a nobody.
So tonight it's a very special honor. It doesn't happen to very many people. They're going to retire your jersey tonight here at your alma mater with USJ. That's got to be a very special feeling.
Yes, it is. I mean, it's really rewarding to have my jersey retired here just because it's just a product of a lot of hard work and effort and sacrifice. They're just like not only me, but like all the girls I played with on all the teams have put in over the years. And it's really an honor just to look back and see, just like have a reminder of all we put into it.
You know, moving on to play college basketball is very special. Not everyone is able to do that. But I have friends that have played high school and college and gone on to play professionally. They always revert back and say, nah, something a little bit more special about my high school days. Do you feel that already, or is that something that comes later, you think?
High school for me is just really special just because I've been at USJ since I was in pre-K. So, like, it wasn't just 4 years for me. It's been forever. And it's just, like, had such a lasting impact, like the friends and the relationships that I've built here just like have stuck with me even through my college years.
Anna Jones, standout here at USJ for 4 years, now playing for Middle Tennessee State University in Murfreesboro. I'll tell you this, Anna, traffic in Murfreesboro is terrible.
It's crazy. It is not like it is here in Jackson, that's for sure.
Well, now what you've missed out is the bypass being shut down.
I've heard all about that, and I'm glad I'm not here to witness it.
That's not fair. It's open this weekend because of the weather. That's not fair either. Anna Jones, tonight, are you nervous? Now, you've been on this floor many times.
I am a little nervous. It's kind of weird being back and not being in a uniform, so it's a little weird for me.
Is that a former teammate right there?
Yes, it is. We got them all here tonight.
So they're coming out, your former teammates coming out to support you. That's nice.
Yes. Yes, it is.
Tony Schutz, you played for him for 4 years, and Stephanie, his wife. What do they mean to you?
They're really everything. You really couldn't ask for better coaches at USJ. They're so much more than just the X's and O's of basketball. What's so special about them is, you know, once you're a Bruin, you're always a Bruin. Like, they keep up with me. I text Stephanie probably three or four times a week. And it's not just me that they keep up with. You know, all their players keep up with whatever's happening in their life and whatnot. So it's just really special to have them here.
Anna Jones. Anna, I'm so happy for you and I'm proud of you. I've known you a long time. And it's going to be a special moment here as
yes.
they retire. Anna Jones, jersey number, what was it, 33?
25.
25. I'm sorry, I just guessed. Anna, thank you. It's great to see you.
You too.
Merry Christmas.
You too.
Anna Jones, what a special player for the USA Lady Bruins. Well, it's time for the second half. 58-6, Lady Bruins with the advantage over Sacred Heart. Dan Reeves, that's my name, along with Will Walker. Boy, Anna Jones was a great player, wasn't she, Will?
Yeah, I mean, you can look at her and tell. You can tell she was an athlete.
When you look at me, I know you get that same feeling. I can tell he was an athlete. You look at a guy like Paul, you say, probably not.
Every time I look at you, Dan, I really think of like a middle linebacker. That's the first thing that pops in my mind.
Well, you're going a long way in this business. Flattery will get you everywhere. The turnover is back to USJ. Will is a sophomore at Sacred Heart. He's like a family to me. I've known his kid since he was born. First time he's been with me broadcasting, and yeah, Sacred Heart's got it. You guys got news over there, big time broadcast. Here's a three. Yes, how about that to start this second half?
Number two, Jasmine Blankenship.
From downtown, Jasmine Blankenship, and a turnover. USA gives it right back as Jasmine Blankenship. Nothing but the bottom of the sack, Will. That was some long range.
Yeah, I mean, with this young team, it's awesome to see. I mean, every now and again, the game will get a little out of hand, but they come right out of half with a little momentum and come and still had the same energies when they started the game.
Tie up, possession arrow to USJ. Game presented by Hardy, Martin, and Owens, the heavy hitters. Right here, Jackson, 424-2151 at first consultation is absolutely free. Emily Jones, a dribble drive in the lane, and a beautiful floater with that left hand at 60-9. That's just an athletic move, isn't it?
Yeah, I mean, she's just a...
Oh, another try, Will. Jasmine Blankenship. Talk about Emily Jones' athleticism, but Jasmine Blankenship is eating up from long range.
Yeah, I mean, that's this is crazy. This is awesome to see Sacred Heart not giving up and really fighting back and then coming out of half and go ahead and popping two threes off real quick.
And a turnover. Sacred Heart gets it back, and yet 60-12, Will, but... not in this half. Rebounded off the missed shot at Emily Jones ahead of Olivia Jones in the front court. It's 6-2 in the second half. Sacred Heart. Here's Cosgrove for a beautiful dish inside. Claire Lewis and company. They go inside with a cutter. Cosgrove for two. It's 62-12. That's how you have to look at turnover. Cosgrove. And then how you have to look at it, Will. Okay, forget about the first half. Let's see if we can outscore them and play with them in the second half.
Yeah, no, I mean, this is a young team. They're still working on things. They're getting all the pieces put together. And right now is a great time to work on everything that was wrong in the first half. You've got to learn to make halftime adjustments and come out and play different. This is a great time to do that.
Another turnover, I think. Oh, look at this. It's the Backstreet Boys are here tonight. I don't know if you get a camera on them. Do you even know who the Backstreet Boys are, Will?
I've heard of them.
Probably because your dad, he used to be his favorite band. Three, on this, that's an air ball. Taken out of the air by Emily. Over to Olivia Jones in the front court. Now down low, Cosgrove dribbled it off her foot and out of bounds to Sacred Heart. The game's presented by the Hughes Eye Group. Aaron Jackson, HughesEye.com, cataract, LASIK, retina, glaucoma, oculoplastics, health and cosmetics, and the best in medical and surgical eye care. 664-1994, 112 Stonebridge, Jackson, the Hughes Eye Group. Here's Olivia Jones, top of the key at the foul line, Outside, yes. Now that was nice. Touch pass from Claire Lewis inside to Cosgrove for 2 points.
It's beautiful how easily they're seeing this offense develop. Their guards at the top of the key are just feeding it down, making beautiful passes, and it's setting up an easy basket.
4 minutes and 57 seconds left. Third quarter, 64-12 USA. Cosgrove travels. She went travel channel. You know, it's, neither one of these teams are very deep, so not a chance to play a lot of play. USA typically a little deeper than they are this year, but for Sacred Heart, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 players on the roster. 64-12 USA, three on its way. No, picked out of the air by Blankenship, who's played her. She's played so well here in the second half, stole it away again. Now Cosgrove, yes, and a foul. Now Blankenship truly played hard here in the second half, hasn't she?
Yeah, no, she always gives a lot of effort. She's got a lot of heart, and you see it every single game. It's game in, game out. She's diving on the floor. She runs the point guard for the Lady Knights offense, and she's always always has this intensity, this fire.
Well, and you know this, you're an athlete, that you learn so much about teamwork and picking up a teammate and discipline, whether it's a baseball field or football field or basketball court, don't you?
Yeah, this is where you really learn and you really get this sense of being on a team right now for the Sacred Heart. By seeing all your teammates are still playing, and they're playing for each other, they're playing for the person beside them, and they're not giving up, and this is where a good team bond is built right here.
Well, they're all of them facing adversity together tonight. It's foul, going to send Blankenship to the line. She may have hurt her hand there on that foul. You face it together. You learn how to face adversity. You're in it together. You win together, you lose together, right?
There's no I in team. You hear that? I mean, it's very cliche, but it's true. This Sacred Heart team really has gone through some adversity the past few years, and but every year they get better and better and better, and it's going to pay off here soon. With the young team, I'm excited to see the future.
Blankenship at the foul line. It's one of two at 66-13. Here's USA, Wagner, backing her defender down and going around her for two, 68-13. USA on the floor, Julie Wagner, Emily Jones, Sarah Beth Browse, also on the floor for USA. Holland Van, a sophomore, is a three. No, it's off the back of the iron. Emily Jones, skies for the rebound. Also on the floor for the Lady Bruins. Who's out there? Molly Strong. Tony shoots. Tony's got his Cassani on tonight. His Wagner. Down low, up strong. No. Rebound Wagner. Up. Yes. Julie Wagner. Going over the top, Will. She's taller and she has longer arms, but now she realizes I'm going to use my advantage. Here's a three. Yep. Guess who? Blankenship from downtown. String music. Hits a tray. 70-13. She's red hot.
Yeah, I mean, coming out of half. Sinking three-pointers, and she's on fire. So, I mean, they're going to keep feeding the hot hand.
And they fouled her, Will. A chance at a four-point play. Looking like Paul Schulze. No, it was, away from the ball. 3:20 left, third quarter, 70-16. Wagner has 10 points in the second half, Blankenship. Wild shot, saved in bounds. At the elbow, now out top of the key is for USA's Browse. Dribbling over on the left wing in front of Tony Schutz with that beautiful Cassani Schutz. Nice defense, stolen away. That's Creasy. Here's a 2-on-2. Creasy, yes, and a foul. On Holland Van, Creasy a chance at a 3-point play. Will she just. Creasy back to Van all the way down under the rim and picked up the foul. Now she have a. Freewood coming.
Yeah, no, it's a good job right there. It's going to get Sacred Heart back on the board, and this team's really playing well right now. If you're just watching this game, you took away the scoreboard off the bottom of your screen, you would have no clue who's winning this game right now. That's awesome.
Creasy, a three-point play, a great point by Will. Here's Wagner stolen away because Sacred Heart has played much better here in the second half, haven't they?
Yeah, no, the intensity is there. I believe that USJ may have lost a little bit of it. I mean, it's hard to play with this big of a lead. But Sacred Heart's really capitalized on that and is playing well right now.
Three shorts, rebound, Caroms out of bounds to USJ. Now, that's an excellent point you made about keeping your intensity up by so many, but it's also tough to play when you're down by that many, isn't it?
Yeah, no, it goes both ways. I mean, most people, you want to just kind of give up and quit and start just going through the motions, but as you can see, the Sacred Heart team is definitely not doing that.
Sarah Beth Brouse fouls. She'll shoot two for USA. My name's Dan Reeves, along with Will Walker, Paul Schulze. Our producer, director, taking care of things. Worthy Road Studios. Brouse free throw, no. Who's your favorite NBA team, Will?
I'm not really gathered roots for a team in the NBA. I like to root for players.
Wayne Volley. What? It's the name on the front of the jersey, Will, not the name on the back of the jersey.
Nah, I mean, I like Giannis Antetokounmpo. How do you say his last name?
Who does he play for?
Nah, he plays for the Bucks out of Milwaukee.
Steel, USA. You know, young people your age, it's more about the individual, isn't it?
Oh, no, definitely. It's about who's going to play good that night and who's going to score the most points. That's what everybody looks for. But, I mean, I like a big fan of Russell Westbrook. I like the explosiveness, and both of those guys are extremely explosive and fun to watch.
Inside Wagner for two more points, this sophomore for USA. 72-19, Lady Bruins. Nice crowd here on a Friday evening on the campus of the University School of Jackson. It's a busy night here, Will, because over at the football stadium, it's the West Tennessee High School Football All-Star Game, sponsored by Sports Plus Rehab Centers. Blankenship nearly not yet another tray, but a gorgeous rebound and putback by our teammates. That's Grace Creasy on that putback. Is Wagner again? Yes, easy as pie. What, Wagner? I don't know. They don't have her height listed. What are you guessing? 6'1", 6'2", maybe?
Yeah, I mean, she's up there. What's even more impressive to me is how fast she gets off. This is a pick and roll at the running, how fast she gets down low. She's, for as big as she is, she's extremely fast and has great footwork down low.
Three shorts out of bounds. It'll stay with Sacred Heart. 51 seconds left. Third quarter, 74-21. Advantage USJ. The Sacred Heart. Oh, she trips. And a kick. Ball stays with Sacred Heart. Student section for USJ. They really get into the games, don't they? Have you noticed that, Will?
Yeah, no, I mean, it's awesome to see everybody coming out and dressed up in their sashes or whatever you call that. I think it's Toga Night. I mean, it's awesome to see everybody kind of getting involved with the game. And
Everyone had a toga expert their high school days. Ours was Adam Minton. Adam, if you're listening, you could probably call in and give us some toga pointers if he remembers.
Do you have a toga?
No, I don't have one. How about you?
I mean, I don't have one, but I'm definitely thinking about getting one for Christmas. I think that's on my list. Actually, for now on, I think I'm going to do all my broadcasts wearing a toga.
Well, you got to get some personality, man. Here's Emily Jones, dribble drive all the way in, can't score. And a foul on Sacred Heart. You really want a toga?
I definitely want a toga.
What do you get a toga? I guess the toga store? I don't know. Do you have any ideas?
I'm thinking, I'm picturing in my mind, I'm thinking about making one myself. just going to go buy some cloth from some Hobby Lobby or wherever you buy cloth from. And it doesn't look that hard. I definitely think I can make it myself.
Can you sew?
No.
Well, you got to learn somewhere, don't you? Your Sacred Heart, 74-21. Talking about togas because USJ student body wearing togas. It's toga night. 4 seconds left in the third. Emily Jones, yes, it's a buzzer. That finger roll. And after three, the Lady Bruins with a 76-21 advantage. We're back in 30 seconds. You're listening to USJ Bruin basketball on WNWS.com.
Once again, Marco's Pizza is the spot for Monday Night Football. The Cheap Seats will be live on the road at Marco's Pizza, 1146 Van Drive. Come join us for amazing Marco's Pizza, wings, subs, and so much more while we get you ready for the big game. Call 300-0400 for delivery or carryout, and don't forget you can order online at marcos.com. A match made in heaven. The Cheap Seats, Monday Night Football, and Marco's Pizza. Truly authentic.
We move to the fourth quarter here at USJ. It's all Lady Bruins, 76-21. My name's Dan Reeves, along with Will Walker, son of Chuck and Christy Walker. Paul Schultz is here, son of Sam. I don't know how many people remember that, son of Sam. 76-21, the advantage, USJ. USJ to start the fourth quarter. It's on the floor as Tony Schultz has emptied the bench. Mayhow, a freshman out there, along with Holland Van, inside a foul. Laney Haynes, another freshman. Molly Strong, a sophomore on the floor for USJ. Mayhow, a freshman. The foul line, Laney Hayes missed the first. For Sacred Hearts, on the floor, Grace Creasy. I don't have a number four on the roster. One of two by Laney Hayes. Do you have a number four on the roster, Will?
Listen, that number four was Asia Thompson.
Asia Thompson, okay. Tie up, possession arrow, Sacred Heart. Caitlin Gill also out there for Sacred Hearts, along with Jasmine Blankenship, who has double digits here in the second half. Well, she's played well.
Yeah, she's played extremely well and really shooting the long ball with extreme excellence. I believe she's 3 of 4 this half, and yeah. Great performance from outside.
Send us a text on the Old Town Spaghetti Store text line. Let us know where you're watching tonight's game. It's 731-277-5155. 277-5155. My name's Dan Reeves, along with Will Walker. Will's a sophomore at Sacred Heart. He's a personal friend of mine. He's studying broadcasting and communications over at Sacred Heart. And it's a pleasure to have Will along. The first of, I hope, many broadcasts.
Yeah, it's a great opportunity. It's a lot of fun. Thank you for having me.
So let us know where you're watching tonight. Text us, Old Town Spaghetti Store text line, 731-277-5155. Coach Joe Holloway and I will be at Cambridge Limited Men's Clothier tomorrow as we get set for Christmas. Tony Schultz, who we mentioned earlier, the best dressed coach in West Tennessee, shops at Cambridge. Look at him tonight. Well-dressed man. You know, the art of dressing has been lost. You don't see many people wear ties these days, do you, Will?
No, sir, you don't.
But when you do, they set themselves apart. It says, okay, that guy right there, he's a go-getter. That's a guy the ladies notice. I bet you have a tie, don't you?
I have a tie somewhere.
Blankenship, another tray went around the rim and crawled out. She was right on the money with that one, just got it spun out on her. 77-21. Lady Bruins inside they go. Howell down the elbow. Is sent it over to corner. Three on its way. No. Rebound. Sacred Heart. Creasy. From the right wing, 15-footer one go. Rebound. Sacred Heart. Taken away by USJ's Lanny Haynes. 4 minutes left in the game. It's 77-21. Lady Bruins looking to go 5-4 on the year. All the way in, but can't finish. Rebound. Lady Bruins strong, and she's fouled. Now, Will, the next game we do not expect to be in any shape, fashion, form similar to this one. It should be a fantastic basketball game.
Yeah, no, I'm excited to see this. I know both teams are pumped up, and as you can see, everybody's really feeling the stands. And there's people from other schools, people that don't even go to either one of these schools here. And this is an exciting game, and everybody knows it.
This text says, can y'all straighten out the play-by-play announcer at the All-Star game? Nothing we can do at Seabass. Here's a breakaway after the steal. Yes, coast to coast for two. Is that Grace Creasy?
No, that is Malia Hughes.
Who's that?
Malia Hughes.
Malia Hughes. This roster is off, isn't it? I think Ray Charles put this roster. It's unusual if one of these numbers is correct.
Yeah, it's
and it's like they're having fun with numbers. Three on its way. Yes! Oh, what a beautiful shot. Emily Gill. 77-26. Lady Bruins. Sacred Heart still playing tough here in the second half. It's foul going to send the Howard Van to the line to shoot a pair. And, Will, that's what you want to see here. The game's out of reach, of course, at halftime. Out of reach, really, at the end of the first quarter. The Sacred Heart really put forth very good effort here in the second half.
Yeah, right now, I mean, I believe it's an extremely close game if you just take just this half, the second half, and Sacred Heart hasn't let up at all and has played much, much better in the second half. I mean, and as a coach, you have to be pleased with your team. Still, after having a rough first quarter and really struggling coming out in the second quarter, making some adjustments in halftime and coming out and playing well.
Both free throws off the mark. Rebound, Sacred Heart, stolen away. Hal has it for USJ. Over to Browse. Here's Sarah Bath in the front court with a minute 14 remaining. Lost it. Had it slapped away. It'll stay with the Lady Bruins. Well, he's starting to feel that momentum pick up for the boys, man. Can you feel it, Will?
Yeah, no. The student section's piling in, and it's getting a little bit louder. There's a little bit more excitement. Everybody's really looking forward to this game right after this one.
Student body chanting. Toga, Toga, inside for two is Van. 79-26, Lady Bruins. Just say good eye with the basketball. Three. No. Looked like it was on the mark, didn't it, Will?
Yeah, just barely. That one bounces off the rim a few times. Everybody holds the breath and then rolls out and just. Unlucky break for Sacred Heart.
We're under the mercy rule, so the clock is, if you're wondering why it's not stopping on that out of bounds, that's why. Three, no. Rebound, USA, that's going to do it. Lady Bruins going to win it big tonight, 79-26 over Sacred Heart. For USA with a win. Proved a 5-4 on the season. for Sacred Hearts. They'll drop to 2-4. Will Linetta even the record in the region at 1-1? But still, it's a tough night tonight, but this young team, they got a long way to go. They showed a lot of intestinal fortitude, played well, I thought. Oh, it played hard in the second half.
Definitely. With a young team, and that's a lot of what you would expect is for this team to come out in the second half and fold up and be a lot like the first half. But it's good to see Coach Dotson's got his team playing hard all four quarters, no matter what the score is.
The Lady Bruins improved to 5-4 on the season. Unbeaten in region play. For Tony Schutz, USA Lady Bruins. Well, they're going to retire Anna Jones's number here at halftime. We'll take a break and we'll come back and we'll set the stage for you as the USA Bruins. And the Sacred Heart boys going to get it on in what should be a fantastic basketball game. That's coming up here just a little bit on WNWS.com. We're back in just a bit.
MasterFit Medical Equipment is on a mission, and that mission is to serve everyone with premium medical equipment at savings you wouldn't find elsewhere. At MasterFit, we represent over 200 medical equipment and supply manufacturers and over 90,000 products, with much of it in our warehouse right here in Jackson. Defibrillators, monitors, EKGs, pumps, sensors, and more. So when you need more affordable medical equipment, call MasterFit Medical Equipment at 554-1223.
Overton Flooring Hardwood Sales and Refinishing in Bells, Tennessee is ready to take your home to the next level with beautiful hardwood flooring selections from hickory, maple, heart of pine, acacia, and distressed oak. At Overton Flooring, we have the only showroom featuring sanded, stained, and finished flooring. If you're ready for a beautiful new look for your home, call the floor guy, Al Overton, at 345-3114. That's 345-3114. Overton Flooring, 12808 Highway 79 in Bells. Open Monday through Friday.
This weekend at Old Town Spaghetti Store, enjoy blackened catfish with shrimp over grits, a blackened catfish fillet and shrimp served with garlic cheese grits, and your choice of house salad or soup, the fresh catch Atlantic salmon, and the soup, creamy chicken and vegetable, and the best prime rib in town, slow roasted and cut to order, tender, juicy, and full of flavor. Happy hour Monday through Friday, 5 to 8 p.m. with half-price drinks. Old Town Spaghetti Store gift certificates make great stocking stuffers. For every $100, get $20 free. Old Town Spaghetti Store, Caritas Drive, Jackson.
Merry Christmas from Outback Steakhouse in Jackson. Outback in Jackson has been voted the best Outback Steakhouse in the entire state of Tennessee. Rankings based on cleanliness, customer service, and of course, food quality. Outback Steakhouse gift cards make great Christmas gifts, and you get $10 for every $50 in gift cards you buy. 50 for them, 10 for you. No limit. It's Outback Steakhouse in Jackson's way of saying thank you and Merry Christmas. Be sure to download the Outback Steakhouse app today for more free goodies from the number one ranked Outback Steakhouse in Tennessee. Outback Steakhouse of Jackson, 194 Stonebrook Place. Open at 4 p.m. weekdays and 11 a.m. on weekends. Call 664-9000 for Outback curbside takeaway. That's 664-9000. Visit OutbackSteakhouse.com for more ways to save money and earn rewards. Outback Steakhouse of Jackson.
Browse tons of new brands with over 500 firearms in stock at RFC Tactical in Milan. RFC Tactical is your largest local direct Benelli, Browning, and H&K dealer in West Tennessee. RFC Tactical is newly located across from Walmart in Milan. You can trust RFC Tactical's experienced, knowledgeable staff to assist you in your next purchase. RFC Tactical can get you started with your first firearm purchase with the right ammo, scope, accessories, and now hunting gear. Let West Tennessee's premier hunting and shooting sports store show you why they support gun rights with their devotion to help protect our children, educate our fellow citizens, and all the while supporting avid hunters and the veteran community. Shop RFC Tactical in Milan Monday through Saturday, 9 a.m. to 7 p.m., or Sunday, noon till 6 p.m.
Hey, Justin here, owner and operator of RFC Tactical. As a former Army combat veteran and family man, I understand the importance of protection. I'll make sure you have a positive experience. It'll be friendly, fast, simple, and the only thing intimidating in here are the firearms.
What? 30 seconds to tell them about Rockin' Dough Pizza?
Here goes.
Try Rockin' Dough's ZZ Tots, shredded potatoes, cheddar, Havarti with a sriracha aioli. Or the Blues Burger, blackened beef, blue cheese, arugula with truffle mayo and a balsamic reduction. The Cuban Grinder with pork, ham, Swiss, pickles, garlic basil aioli, and a grained mustard. The Super Freak Pizza, my favorite. White sauce, spicy Italian sausage with caramelized onions and honey. And their fantastic Sunday brunch. Rockin' Dough in the Jackson Walk Plaza, a slice of the good life.
Range USA is Jackson's only indoor shooting range and open to the public 7 days a week. Monday is family day. Tuesday is first responders and healthcare day. Wednesday is free gun rentals. Thursday is ladies day and educators day. Friday, pro gun day. Range USA offers Tennessee handgun permit classes on Saturday and so many other classes you'll love. Sunday, bring your church bulletin and get a free target. Range USA, North Highland behind Taco Bell, Facebook and rangeusa.com.
It's going down this Thursday at the Blacksmith Bar and Grill. Thursday nights during football season, the Cheap Seats will be live at the Blacksmith for Thursday Night Throwdown. Football fans will have cornhole, ping pong, and we'll be giving away Titans tickets to some lucky winner, courtesy of MasterFit Medical. Located at 216 North Shannon Street, across from the Farmer's Market. Try the Johnny Cakes, or fried green tomatoes, or the Molten Burger. Maybe it's the hot chicken sandwich or the blackened shrimp. Thursday night's new home for football is the Blacksmith Bar and Grill. Downtown Jackson, across from the Farmer's Market.
Shop CarLock Nissan of Jackson on-site or online today. CarLock's new and used Nissan dealership in Jackson has stylish, competitively priced new options to explore. So don't put off your search for a Nissan any longer. CarLock's knowledgeable, experienced sales staff is committed to delivering a high quality of service that enables you to shop confidently. At CarLock Nissan of Jackson, we not only believe in supporting our customers, but in supporting the community we're proud to be a part of. We contribute to many causes and organizations, such as the Susan B. Komen Foundation and the Wounded Warrior Project. Slip behind the wheel of a new Nissan Altima for an invigorating test drive or learn about the active safety features that come standard on the Rogue. Visit CarLock Nissan of Jackson today. We have an on-site finance department that will assist you with your bad credit, car loan needs, and a service team that will keep your purchase healthy for many years to come. Don't miss your chance to own a versatile new Nissan Versa today. Visit our dealership on Van Drive in Jackson today.
There's several occasions in life when a man just needs to look good. And at Cambridge Limited Men's Clothier, we understand those moments.
Sally, will you go to the prom with me?
I would, but you look like a hobo.
Do you take this man to be your husband?
Not dressed like that, I won't.
Located on North Highland across from Toys R Us, Cambridge has the best tie selection in town, plus the best price. Size selections 36 short to 54 long and up. We have a tailor on staff and offer law enforcement specials on suits. Cambridge Limited Men's Clothier, North Highland, across from Toys R Us.
You know the temperature in your home? You should. If your system isn't operating properly, you can't stay cool in the steaming summer months that are to come. That's where Garrett Plumbing and Heating Company can help. With years of experience, Garrett services and repairs residential customers. They also provide estimates on new installations. Quality is job one at Garrett. Call 668-3339 and let Garrett Plumbing and Heating and Air go to work for you today.
At Home Medical Products, we provide patients with products to make sure you breathe, sleep, move, and live well. With items like nebulizers, travel oxygen, CPAPs, hospital beds, wheelchairs, scooters, lift chairs, commodes, and so much more. You have a choice when choosing Home Medical Companies. It's the patient's choice. Make the right choice. Locally owned and operated Home Medical Products. Call 877-660-0084 or find them online at hmpinc.net.
Don't worry, ooh, be happy. This is Tammy Reed telling you not to worry when it comes to real estate. Turn it over to the number one real estate team in West Tennessee. We will take all the worries out of your real estate experience. No gimmicks, no unkept promises, just happy clients. Call the Reed Nelson team, Hickman Realty Group, 664-1006. Don't worry, be happy.
Legal problems don't always arise Monday through Friday, 8 to 5. When you need an attorney, you need them now. This is Bradley Owens of Hardy Martin and Owens Law Firm. Add my cell number to your contacts. 234-2400. That's 234-2400. At Hardy Martin and Owens, we handle all types of legal problems, including personal injury, workers' compensation, divorce and family law, estates, and criminal defense. With offices in Jackson and Trenton, let Hardy Martin and Owens handle all your legal needs. 424-2151 or on my cell, 234-2400.
Tipping the scales in your favor.
Welcome to Hughes Eye. Our doctors and staff look forward to having you as a patient at our clinic. Our doctors and staff work together as a team to treat patients with outstanding care in a positive and friendly environment. We work closely with your local eye and medical doctors to provide care centered around you. Hughes Eye has offices throughout West Tennessee to better serve you. We offer cataract, LASIK, and glaucoma procedures, retina and oculoplastic specialties, as well as the treatment and management of many ocular diseases. We're proud to offer advanced technology to provide the most up-to-date treatment options for your eyes. Prior to your appointment, please take a moment to visit our website at HughesEye.com. There, you can submit new patient forms, find directions to our clinics, and learn more about your ocular condition.
The Hughes Eye Group, 112 Stonebridge, Jackson. The best in medical and surgical eye care. Call 731-664-1994 and visit HughesEye.com.
Once again, Marco's Pizza is the spot for Monday Night Football. The Cheap Seats will be live on the road at Marco's Pizza, 1146 Van Drive. Come join us for amazing Marco's Pizza, wings, subs, and so much more while we get you ready for the big game. Call 300-0400 for delivery or carryout, and don't forget you can order online at marcos.com. A match made in heaven. The Cheap Seats, Monday Night Football, and Marco's Pizza. Truly authentic.
MasterFit Medical Equipment is on a mission, and that mission is to serve everyone with premium medical equipment at savings you wouldn't find elsewhere. At MasterFit, we represent over 200 medical equipment and supply manufacturers and over 90,000 products, with much of it in our warehouse right here in Jackson. Defibrillators, monitors, EKGs, pumps, sensors, and more. So when you need more affordable medical equipment, call MasterFit Medical Equipment at 554-1223.
Overton Flooring, Hardwood Sales, and Refinishing in Bells, Tennessee is ready to take your home to the next level with beautiful hardwood flooring selections from hickory, maple, heart of pine, acacia, and distressed oak. At Overton Flooring, we have the only showroom featuring sanded, stained, and finished flooring. If you're ready for a beautiful new look for your home, call the floor guy, Al Overton, at 345-3114. That's 345-3114. Overton Flooring, 12808 Highway 79 in Bells. Open Monday through Friday.
This weekend at Old Town Spaghetti Store, enjoy blackened catfish with shrimp over grits, a blackened catfish fillet and shrimp served with garlic cheese grits, and your choice of house salad or soup, the fresh catch Atlantic salmon, and the soup, creamy chicken and vegetable, and the best prime rib in town, slow roasted and cut to order, tender, juicy, and full of flavor. Happy hour Monday through Friday, 5 to 8 p.m. with half-price drinks. Old Town Spaghetti Store gift certificates make great stocking stuffers. For every $100, get $20 free. Old Town Spaghetti Store, Caritas Drive, Jackson.
Merry Christmas from Outback Steakhouse in Jackson. Outback in Jackson has been voted the best Outback Steakhouse in the entire state of Tennessee. Rankings based on cleanliness, customer service, and of course, food quality. Outback Steakhouse gift cards make great Christmas gifts, and you get $10 for every $50 in gift cards you buy. 50 for them, 10 for you. No limit. It's Outback Steakhouse in Jackson's way of saying thank you and Merry Christmas. Be sure to download the Outback Steakhouse app today for more free goodies from the number one ranked Outback Steakhouse in Tennessee. Outback Steakhouse of Jackson, 194 Stonebrook Place. Open at 4 p.m. weekdays and 11 a.m. on weekends. Call 664-9000 for Outback curbside takeaway. That's 664-9000. Visit OutbackSteakhouse.com for more ways to save money and earn rewards. Outback Steakhouse of Jackson.
Browse tons of new brands with over 500 firearms in stock at RFC Tactical in Milan. RFC Tactical is your largest local direct Benelli, Browning, and H&K dealer in West Tennessee. RFC Tactical is newly located across from Walmart in Milan. You can trust RFC Tactical's experienced, knowledgeable staff to assist you in your next purchase. RFC Tactical can get you started with your first firearm purchase with the right ammo, scope, accessories, and now hunting gear. Let West Tennessee's premier hunting and shooting sports store show you why they support gun rights with their devotion to help protect our children, educate our fellow citizens, and all the while supporting avid hunters and the veteran community. Shop RFC Tactical in Milan Monday through Saturday, 9 a.m. to 7 p.m. or Sunday, noon till 6 p.m.
Hey, Justin here, owner and operator of RFC Tactical. As a former Army combat veteran and family man, I understand the importance of protection. I'll make sure you have a positive experience. It'll be friendly, fast, simple, and the only thing intimidating in here are the firearms.
What? 30 seconds to tell them about Rockin' Dough Pizza?
Here goes.
Try Rockin' Dough ZZ Tots, shredded potatoes, cheddar, Havarti with a sriracha aioli. Or the Blues Burger, blackened beef, blue cheese, arugula with truffle mayo and a balsamic reduction. The Cuban Grinder with pork, ham, Swiss, pickles, garlic, basil aioli, and a grained mustard. The Super Freak Pizza, my favorite. White sauce, spicy Italian sausage with caramelized onions and honey. And their fantastic Sunday brunch. Rockin' Dough in the Jackson Walk Plaza, a slice of the good life.
I know, right? Here we go.
Well, getting set for USJ versus Sacred Heart, the boys' game. My name's Dan Reeves, along with my good friend, Chuck Walker. Hey, Chuck, how you doing, man?
Man, I am doing great. And I tell you what, like, you know, this is one of my favorite things about high school sports. Sometimes emotion is palpable. You can feel it right now. Did you feel the energy kick up a little bit when you came back up here? This is – we just saw a great game, and USJ performed extremely well against a young Sacred Heart team. But, man, these stands filled up to max capacity. You got two raucous student sections. This is a true battle of McClellan Road right here. I'm totally excited.
It is their neighbors, Sacred Heart and USJ. Paul Schulze, our producer and director. And what a job the young Will Walker did in his first color commentary. He does it with Sacred Heart's broadcast.
Yeah, he does it with a broadcasting class. But it's first time working with a professional.
Well, me too. Pardon me, man. The explosive cough. I apologize for that. Sacred Heart, man, I tell you, this team is Nicholas Boygarden, head coach, Charles Dodson, the assistant. And, boy, you know, they come in with a record of 3-4, 0-1 in the region, so tonight's a big game for Sacred Heart. But, Chuck, they've been missing a key component to this team.
Oh, yeah, don't let that 3-4 record fool you in the slightest. This team's got very, very close loss to Humboldt. Tough loss to FACS where they underperformed. They were up by 10, I think, with 30 seconds left. It's just kind of one of those games that sometimes you can have. But this team right here, you can feel it when you walk through the schools. You can hear it when you talk to the players. This team has very, very high expectations for this season, and they should. This is a senior-laden team. Just about everybody, all the starters and most of the reserves are seniors. So this is, this is the big year for them.
For USJ, they got a brand new head coach for the USJ Bruins. And the former coach, I noticed, Oliver Simmons is here tonight to watch this game.
Well, that's awesome, man. I'm glad he came out.
He's over in Haywood County. Yeah, it's going to get loud. It is loud. They turn the lights down and announce the Bruins starters. We'll just let you take this in. Quite a scene here at USJ. We're ready for some basketball. These neighbors, they don't like each other. Hey, you know what? And it's a big region matchup tonight. And Chuck, we expect it to be a fantastic game.
Yeah, I think you've got a great one coming. And I would tell you this. I think the louder they boo both teams and the more they yell, that shows how much they respect each other. You know what I mean? I think it speaks a lot to both programs. And, USJ's been the gold standard for this area for a long, long time. And you got a school like Sacred Heart, hopefully up on the rise. And so this is a big game for both programs. Who wants to be the king of McClellan? Should be a lot of fun, man. You're going to be able to feel this through the airwaves.
This is for bragging rights on McClellan. USJ controls the chip. And we're underway for USJ, the starters. Jacob Adkins, Colby Hughes, Stanton McFarland, Tanner Atkins, all on the floor for the Bruins. Tanner Atkins' grandfather watching, and D.C. tonight, grandson of John Tanner. Hello, John. He's watching his Sacred Heart traveling after the USA miss.
Yeah, just one too many steps there for Harris on that. He had an open lane coming in hard. I tell you what, it looks like both teams do it, but I know the Knights do it. They're going to run the ball and push it really hard to keep that action fast-paced.
Kobe Rhodes, the newcomer here, the other starter, the fifth starter for USJ. He's off to a great start with his brewing career. Here's McFarland, a three, no, it rattled out of there. Rebound, Sacred Heart, Kevin Marcel, Harris Barker, Tariq Williams. Dante Williamson for Sacred Heart, a three. It's an air ball taken by Roach. And boy, you don't want to shoot an air ball tonight. That student body going to let you hear it, too.
I tell you what, you're going to know about it for a little bit. Both student bodies packed the stands tonight. And I'm telling you, think a little nerves here in the beginning. Couple of bad shots, couple of turnovers.
Aiden Adwall, the fifth starter for Sacred Heart. He's an old friend of mine. Here's Roach inside. Fouled. For Sacred Heart, the head coach, Nicholas Beauregard, assisted by Charles Dotson. USJ, the first-year head coach, Hamilton Hudson, assisted by Bill Hopkins and Ken Watts. For the Bruins, Roach, free throw, yes.
No, that's Tariq's first foul. And Tariq plays a lot of the forward-slash-center position for the Knights, and he's going to have to stay out of foul trouble. He's the main rebounder, cleans the glass up, keeps the action moving.
Roach hits both free throws. And the Bruins take a 2-0 lead. This game presented by Sonic of Jackson with six Jackson locations. Sonic of Jackson. Here's Madwall. He'll send it over the corner. Got him trapped. Back to Madwall. Three on its way. No. Tanner Atkins rebound. Tanner puts a good player. Competitive. Beautiful dish. Yes.
Nice pass right there to Tanner, to McFarland. I tell you what, that's the way you want to start if you're the Bruins here.
4-0 Bruins. Tanner Atkins wiped that glass clean and assisted on the other end to McFarland. It's 4-0 Bruins. 6:09 left. First quarter. Here's a tray. Hit the backboard. Taken off that backboard by Colby Hughes. Son of Match. His grandfather's here tonight, Gary Deaton.
I saw him in the concession stand earlier. Wouldn't give me a drink.
And his hair was perfect.
It was very nice hair.
If hair could smile, it would look like Gary Deaton's hair in a turnover. Back to USA it goes with 5:53 left in the opening quarter. It's 4-0 Bruins. Great to have you along with us. Text us. Let us know where you're watching tonight's game. You can text us on the Old Town Spaghetti Store text line at 277-5155. Texas, let us know. Here's Sacred Heart working inside and a foul.
Oh, it's a charge on Tariq. That's going to be his second foul with just a couple of minutes into the game. And we talked about it a second ago, Dan. You got to be really careful here if you're the Knights. That's two fouls in 3 minutes.
Well, and Chuck, you're pointing out something very important up for Tariq. He means so much to this team. At 6'5", playing for the first time in a while, a lot of confidence getting him back, but he's in trouble already. Atkins off the glass, no. Rebound, Sacred Heart. That's Williamson on the move. He'll dish down low, spinning, twisting, shooting. It went around the rim and came out. And off of Sacred Heart out of bounds to USA. Well, wait a minute. I think they're gonna
confer here. That looks like it maybe hit both of them here. I tell you, the Sacred Heart's just not getting anything to roll in right now. That call was reversed. It's going to be ninth. Knights are going to contain possession. Take it out from the baseline.
Now the big man, 6'11", Nana Malik, comes in, a senior. 6'11". Sacred Heart on the right wing. Good perimeter defense. Now they work in the corner. Here's Madwall, left wing. Back in the paint. Yes. A beautiful dribble drive by Williamson. That was strong.
That was really strong. And I tell you, Dante, I've seen him play three or four games now, and that's his move. When he goes to the glass, the touch that he has off the back glass there, man, he's really, really hard to defend. He gave Humboldt a lot of trouble earlier in the year. That's something they're going to want to put a stop on.
Jacob Atkins took one off the kisser, I believe. So I think he may have had some, maybe a bloody nose there, attempting him. So USA burns a timeout. 2:56 left in the first quarter. It's 4-2 USA. But Chuck, this has a tournament-type atmosphere. It's great to see this. Kids are so close together, proximity. they really get after one another.
Yeah, they did. And I was up at the at Sacred Heart today helping with the broadcasting program, and you would see different things come across on Twitter. You know, different kids would talk about, you hear this, you see this, and going back and forth. You got signs over here. It's a lot of fun. And I'm going to tell you one of the reasons why is kid Harris Parker here. He was at USJ last year, got hurt, never played, transferred to Sacred Heart this year, eligible to play. And so Harris knows a lot of these guys and has played with a lot of these guys for a lot of years. So there's a lot of fun, a lot of good feeling between both teams.
A lot of storylines, isn't it?
There are a lot of storylines.
Makes it a lot of
fun. Such is life.
It is. Such is life. Such is Paul Schulze, folks. Our producer and director, Mr. Paul Schulze. So, the official still conferencing, and they're not going to allow. Wait a minute. So is that so? Williamson's headed to the locker room or concession stand, I'm not sure.
Yeah, I'm assuming locker room. I don't know what could have in the world could have happened there.
Wesley Carlock into the game to replace Jacob Atkins, who took one to the face. Here's Carlock, dribble drive, cut off in the lane. Now Hughes, three on its way. Hit the front of the iron, rebound, Wesley Carlock pulls it outside. That's Clay and Luann's son. Here's Roach in the paint. Twisted, turning.
Really nice, travel. Hard move. Yeah, got to travel there. That basket's not going to count, but I like what he's doing and how he's getting his own space down there.
Well, he's can't match up height-wise with a 6'11", the big man down low, Malik. But Chuck, he's stronger, wider, and he pointed out he's using that strength to – for some separation.
Yeah, he's keeping his body low, and that's something I know that Nana Malik has worked with a lot in the offseason. Very raw when he first got to Sacred Heart last year.
Here's McFarland with a steal. Over to Tanner Atkins. Here's Tanner. Had it deflected away. It'll stay with USJ.
Yeah, Marcel deflected that.
This game brought to you in part by Rockin' Dough Pizza, downtown Jackson, on the Jackson Walk. Chuck and I have eaten there many times.
Oh, man, one of my favorite places. Oh, it signifies downtown. I love the downtown area.
And a great. Here's Roach off the inbound. Now Kobe Hughes to McFarland, top of the key. Stanton wants to drive, travels. Well, good defense by Malik. The big man was moving his feet, Chuck, and that's key for a big man defensively because they got big feet, and these kids in high school are just growing into their size. Great defense.
Yeah, it really is, and I tell you, you got two different defensive styles here. Looks like USJ's running the zone. Sacred Heart staying man-to-man right now. That's why you see a 6'11 guy at the top of the key on defense there.
The Sacred Hearts traveling. Malik, that wasn't really his fault. That was... That pass got on him in a hurry as Jacob Atkins comes back into the game, and Wesley Carlock will set. I've had a sinus infection all week. I ran into Wesley. That's physician's quality care. So he was battling something too early in the week.
Man, I tell you what, it's that time. Dante Williamson with the block here. Dante taking it himself. So he came back from that locker room trip.
That was a beautiful play. Dante Williamson, a 6'6 senior for Sacred Heart. We're tied at four. Here's Tanner Atkins, fouled on the floor. It'll be team foul number three on Sacred Heart.
That's Kevin Marcel's first foul. Kevin plays guard. He's a sophomore, getting a lot of playing time. I tell you, I've gone to a lot of Sacred Heart games so far, and they got a different starting lineup every game.
Three, Jacob Atkins, shorts, rebound McFarland, dishes, Atkins, yes, Tanner Atkins. Two, a beautiful wraparound pass from Stan McFarland. Chuck, that was a beauty.
It really was, and I'm really surprised how well USJ is controlling the post down there. They're really getting it when they need it.
Malik travels again, and the Cardinals send for a big man, Chuck. He brought the ball down low instead of high where they can't get it.
Yeah, and that's what I was telling you, Dan. He's still a little raw around the edges. He's got a ton of intangibles. You can't teach that size or strength. I've seen the man carry six pallets at one time. That right there, though, the traveling, the not anticipating the pass, that's what can get him. Otherwise, he's got everything else you're looking at or looking for.
A beautiful bounce pass from Colby Hughes to Tanner Atkins. Atkins will foul to shoot two. For Malik, that's his first team foul number four. On the Sacred Heart, Malik will sense Into the game for Sacred Heart comes Will Kyle, 5'11 junior. Tanner Atkins misses his first, hits his second, and the Bruins have a 7-4 lead.
Yeah, that was actually Harris Barker that checked in real quick there, Dan. He's gone back. He's just going in to get the rebound there. Harris, the tall kid, 6'5".
You mentioned earlier Harris Barker last year was playing here for the Bruins.
Yeah, got injured before the season started and came over to finish his season, senior season at Sacred Heart.
2:37 left in the first quarter, 7-4 Bruins. Here's Matt Waugh for Sacred Heart. It's nearly stolen. It's out of bounds off of Jacob Atkins. So we got Jacob Atkins and Tanner Atkins. No relation. Here's Matt Waugh. Oh, nearly traveled. Good defense by Atkins. They send it around on the right wing. Williamson.
Dante, you got fouled
by Tanner Atkins. He'll shoot two as the elevation to get that separation. I mean, I tell you, he can elevate with the best of them.
He can.
That's Dante Williamson. Tanner Atkins can as well, but Chucky hacked him. Issue two.
He did, and it's something I like to see Dante when he's doing. He's impressive to watch. When he's up, it seems like he moves side to side in the air, and he can control his body and still get that shot off. And that's tough to defend. When you jump straight up and someone's going sideways, it's tough not to foul.
With hang time.
Exactly.
All free throws good by Williamson. It's a one-point game. It's a long
pass
down the floor.
Yeah.
And Madois slaps it away and out of bounds. I tell you, Aiden Madois, I like that kid. He was best friends with Cameron Greer growing up, so I've known him a long time.
Yeah, he's a great guy. Comes from a great family. I really like Aiden. Very, very polite kid. Good athlete. Great effort. Fun to watch.
Here's Tanner Atkins, 7-6. Bruins, Tanner, spinning, dishing. It's slapped away. Roach lost it. A foul on Sacred Heart. That's just a tough luck foul right there out of hustle, trying to run down a loose ball.
Yeah, his name's number 13, Colin Holder, going out there, and he will give it all he's got on the floor. He's fun to watch. He's a good basketball player, and he is a phenomenal baseball player. Somebody watch out for this year for Sacred Heart.
Travel. Back to Sacred Heart. What about Sacred Heart baseball this year? What do you expect?
Well, you know, we got a young team. We're going to have, you know, what looks like to be maybe three or four freshman starters with another two or three sophomore starters, junior and a senior. So it'll be a lot of fun. A lot of kids have played a lot of travel ball, a lot of innings log. It'll be a good time. I can't wait. My son's a big baseball player, so I love watching any high school baseball anywhere.
Oh, isn't that fun, boy, I tell you. Getting complaints about the play-by-play over the football game. Said the man, can y'all straighten out the line announcer at the All-Star game? He's calling the names of the blue as the folks with the ball. They may be talking about the house announcer. That's what
doesn't sound like bass. And I know that's in a URI.
No, the All-Star football game's happening right next door to us at USJ in Sports Plus Rehab Center. High school football All-Star game. The folks with the ball. This game brought to you in part by Sarah of Jackson. One destination and so many choices. Sarah of Jackson. By King Jewelers. Grover Blue Eyes King, the best selection of jewelry, the best prices. Free gift wrapping for Christmas. King Jewelers, 16 Conrad Drive. Yeah, Rolex there from King Jewelers.
Man, that's nice. Ain't nice money, baby.
Madois, three. No. Saved inbounds, taken by Atkins. Minute 41 left in the first quarter, 7-6, advantage USJ. Here's McFarland left wing. That's batted away, the pass out of the air, out of Beard. It got there quickly. Chuck had swatted it away. It'll stay with the Bruins.
Yeah, it will. And Kendrick Beard's another player to watch for the next few years. He's a sophomore, played at Southside, slotted to play at Southside, came over to a Sacred Heart last year. A lot of energy, really good point guards, only going to get better as time goes on.
Here's Roach down low. No. Taken out of there by Williamson. He's off and running. It's a one-on-three. Williamson says, I'll take those numbers. And Sacred Heart takes a one-point lead.
And I'm telling you, Dan, when Dante drives the lane, he can kiss it off the glass. I don't know how you defend that. I just know you got to.
Almost a minute left here in the first quarter. 8-7. It's a 4-0 run by Sacred Heart, and they have the advantage. Both these student sections getting after it. They want to one-up the other one, don't they?
They really do. You see a lot of signs. But I tell you, what's happening on the floor, you see 10 guys laying out 100%. I can't do that math, but I know there's a lot of effort going on right now. Look at this.
Look at that defense right there, I tell you. That's going to go out of bounds and stay with USJ. Roach did a great job when he went to the floor to keep that dribble alive.
Yeah, no, he really did. I'm telling you, this is a fun watch right now. I hope this action stays up through all four quarters.
Atkins to pull the trigger. Nearly stolen by Madwall. Here's Kobe Hughes in the paint. The teardrop, no. Kept alive by Tanner Atkins, but out of bounds. Hughes tried to save it, but couldn't. With 44 seconds left in the first quarter, Sacred Heart gets it back. But, Chuck, one thing's obvious to me is those good looks by USJ have gone away. Great defense by Sacred Heart.
Yeah, you know, and they're still staying with the man. They're tightening up a little bit. You know, emotion can carry us through the first few minutes. And, you know, 30 seconds left in the first quarter. We're kind of seeing both teams settle in a little bit, but still great effort.
Sacred Heart with 27 seconds. Williamson from the elbow. No, it's too strong. Williamson gets his own rebound. And Madwall comes away with it. 19 seconds. Stolen by Jacob Atkins.
Way to stand in the lane and take that pass right there. I tell you what, those are good eyes by Atkins there.
So USA with a chance at the final look at Odd. Williamson picks the pocket of Atkins. Williamson, no! Oh, they're going to call a foul on Tanner Atkins. That's unfortunate. He was just standing there with his hands up.
He was. I think you have a 3-foot center under the goal where you can't stand in there and block it or it's a foul.
Well, he was on the move and it was coming off the rim. That's a tough one there. I'll give to the official. He was closer than I. Yeah. It's a reason why they don't put the officials up here to call the game, I guess.
Well, you're right about that. But now both Williams and Atkinson have two fouls apiece.
At the buzzer, Williamson, no. Oh, what a first quarter, though. Sacred Heart finishes the first quarter on a 4-0 run to take a one-point advantage. After one, we're back in 30 seconds. USJ Bruin basketball on WNWS.com.
Range USA is Jackson's only indoor shooting range and open to the public 7 days a week. Monday is Family Day. Tuesday is First Responders and Healthcare Day. Wednesday is Free Gun Rentals. Thursday is Ladies Day and Educators Day. Friday, Pro Gun Day. Range USA offers Tennessee handgun permit classes on Saturday and so many other classes you'll love. Sunday, bring your church bulletin and get a free target. Range USA, North Highland behind Taco Bell, Facebook, and RangeUSA.com.
Hey, real good.
This look back here with you. It's USJ. After one quarter, it's 8-7. Sacred Heart. My name's Dan Reeves, along with Chuck Walker, producing and directing as Paul Schulze, and we thank Drew Magruder. He's like a big old angel over there in Brownsville, just hovering over us to make sure everything's lovely. What a first quarter, Chuck. It's 8-7, a one-point lead by the visitors, Sacred Heart.
You know, I wouldn't have guessed that we'd have had a total of 15 points in the first quarter, especially the way this fast-paced as the game has been. This hasn't been a ball-control game. This has been two teams pushing it and also playing great defense.
So Sacred Heart with the basketball and a one-point lead as we begin quarter number two. Here on this beautiful campus, Williamson with a drive, a stop, a shoot, and a score. Hey, Chuck, he didn't take it all the way. He got down low there. When the defense came up, he just elevated for two.
Yeah, and floated it in. I'm telling you, Dante is really hard to defend. I know there's a handful of Division I programs looking at him right now. He's got a lot of intangibles.
Here's Kobe Hughes, three.
Wow, that looked like Steph Curry right there. That's a high floating three, man. I tell you what, Kobe's got a high arch to his shot. That was beautiful.
Son of Matt Hughes, grandson of Gary Deaton. Here's Sacred Heart, they follow, no. Rebound, Kobe Hughes, but tied at 10. And yes, he does have that release, much like the man from Golden State. Steph Curry. Yes.
Right.
Steal. Sacred Heart. Here's Colin a two Holder. On one. Williamson. Yes, and a foul.
And one right there. Nice pass by Holder as Williamson was diving. It was going in, and there's really nothing you can do there other than foul and try to break that up because that's an easy layup.
Well, Williamson, when he elevates, it's over. You got to get him before he elevates if you're going to get him. Now he'll have a chance at a 3-point play. Went around the rim and came out. Roach on the rebound. It's 12-10, Sacred Heart. USA having trouble with the Sacred Hearts. defense. Here's Tanner Atkins left wing. He'll go into Roach. Roach elevates. No. Good defense by Williamson.
Really nice stepping up there from that entry pass. Harrison Barker, nice rebound.
Here's Sacred Heart. Kevin Marcel. Again.
That floater in the lane's there.
Marcel with that teardrop floater. After tied at 10, it's another spurt for Sacred Heart.
You know, I like the adjustment from the Knights. When you're doing that zone defense, that's really the best way to go at it.
McFarland, right wing, just inside the arc. It's a two-point game. Sacred Heart down to four quickly. Barker travels. Well, that was, he felt like he was pushed by Kobe Hughes. He's pleading his case to the Zebra, and the Zebra said, play ball, boys.
Well, it's fast-paced and hard-hitting as this game is. You're going to get away with a little bump right there. Sacred Heart wants that bump, too, to not be a foul.
If you've never played basketball and you don't think it's a demanding sport, but you haven't played. McFarland, no. Off the back end, Roach keeps it alive with a rebound outside to Hughes. Over to Wesley Carlock. Here's Tanner Atkins in the right wing. And he's fouled on the floor. That's going to be team foul number six on Sacred Heart. So from this point forward, it'll be USJ in the bonus the rest of the first half.
Yeah, I didn't pick up who that foul was on. I believe they said number five, Dante Williamson. If that's so, that's his first.
Here's McFarland. Picked up his dribble. Now Carlock working the baseline all the way in. Yes, that's what Wesley Carlock can do. He's great off that dribble drive.
He really is, and he's taking that right there to the lane. Both teams are getting tons of points in the paint.
We're tied at 14. USJ counters at 4-0 spurt by Sacred Heart with one of their own. Sacred Heart can't connect from downtown. Rebound USJ.
You know, Dan, I'm really impressed with how Roach is controlling the glass on both sides, on offense and defense, tipping it out, giving USJ an extra shot on offense and tipping it back on defense so they can bring the ball down.
Nice crowd here at USJ on a Friday evening, mid-December, well, early December. Look at Tanner Atkins, that slash. He's fouled. Who got him?
Yeah, it's going to be on Dante Williamson there. That's his second foul. Two shots coming up, and I'll tell you, that's the second foul for Dante. At some point of the game, that comes into play.
Well, Dante picks up his second. He's going to sit for, well, I thought he was. Tanner Atkins, beautiful dribble drive. He is a slasher and a half. Grandson of Congressman John Tanner, who's watching tonight at Washington, D.C., behind closed doors.
Mr. Tanner. And I can tell you what, you know what I'm so impressed with USJ right now? They're outsized, but they are going straight to the lane. They are driving down for layups time after time again.
Tanner Atkins hits both free throws, and the Bruins on a 6-0 spurt and a two-point lead. A tray, shorts, rebound, Roach again, as that tray by Marcel just off the front of the iron, and Chuck, there's your man again, Roach on the glass.
I'm telling you, he is. I don't know how the box score is going to, you know, shake out with all the tip pass or the tip rebounds he's had, but he's really, really helped the Bruins out here.
McFarland, strong move down low, but can't finish. Good defense by Dante Williamson, especially when you consider he's got two fouls on him. And McFarland knew it, tried to pick up his third. It's out of bounds, however, to USA. Carlock will pull the trigger.
Beautiful inbounds play.
Tanner Atkins caught it in midair, went off the glass, and the Bruins with an 8-0 run and a four-point lead with 4:39 left in the second quarter here at the University School of Jackson. Here's Williamson. Madwoff fires a tray. Nope. Rebound. Kobe Hughes.
And I tell you, that outside shot is just not there for the Knights tonight. They've had their success when they've driven the lane. I hate to see them pull away from it here, but, boy, I tell you, USJ is making all the right moves right now.
Wesley Carlock, now Tanner Atkins. Inside McFarland against Williamson. Two fouls, and he takes it right at him for two more. It's a
TNO
run by the Bruins and a six-point Bruin lead.
McFarland and Roach are dominating the post right now on both sides of the ball. There's no other way you can talk about it.
And Sacred Heart is shaking, Chuck. There's a not so common mental mistake by Williamson. He'll sit with those two fouls as Harris Barker replaces him for Sacred Heart. Here's Tanner Atkins. He'll stop. He'll shoot. He'll miss. He'll rebound. Atkins fouled. He'll shoot two.
And I can tell you what, one more time, McFarland there will not end up on the stat sheet, but the way he boxed out, giving him that layup shot, I know it didn't go in, but he gave him a clear lane to take that layup in.
The little things, Chuck notices those. That's why he's here tonight. Tanner, free throw short. 3:52 left in the first quarter. We thank our sponsors that include Premier Dental Center in Jackson, Bales, and Milan. PrimDent.com, they're my dentists. They're the best. Premier Dental Center is Tanner Atkins. It's one of two. It's a 11-0 run by the Bruins, and USJ has a 7-point advantage. 3:45 left before halftime. And a kick ball.
I tell you, they're closing down those passing lanes. Sacred Heart likes to operate at the top of the key and then penetrate in through, and USJ is really that zone defense, staying in those passing lanes.
Barker, three, no. Rebound, Wesley Carlock. USJ goes Wesley Carlock, Tanner Atkins, Kobe Hughes, Stat McFarland. Here's Roach inside. He's fouled. He'll shoot two. Kobe Roach headed to the foul line. So it's Kobe Roach, Wesley Carlock, Stat McFarland, Kobe Hughes, Tanner Atkins. So the only... the non-starter on the floor is Wesley Carlock. Jacob Atkins may have took an elbow to the nose earlier. He's getting set to check back in, but Wesley Carlock, he's been productive since coming in here in the first half.
And what a spark off the bench you can have. How nice is that? And I know we keep talking about these fouls, but Colin Holder, who's another forward for Sacred Heart, is expected to clean the glass up. That's his second foul now.
Roach misses both free throws. He has an unorthodox style for the free throw line. Typically, though, he's a good free throw shooter. That time he was off the mark. 21-14, USJ by 7. 3:18 left. Second quarter here at USJ. Adwog sends it over the corner. A three is on its way. Went around the rim and came out. Barker with a strong rebound. Put back. No rebound. Roach has it. Kobe Roach, another rebound. Out in front, Kobe Hughes. Here's McFarland, three, no. Rebound Roach again, and he's fouled.
I'm telling you, Roach is doing everything for this Bruin team right now. What he's doing down low, he was the only guy. There were three knights right on top of him. He jumped up, he fought for the ball, he kicked it back there. He's drawing the fouls. That's going unnoticed, too. He is really, this is his game right now.
Well, and you're right, second chance opportunities are killers on the scoreboard and also in the head. You know, you get frustrated with that, but Roach has missed his third consecutive free throw.
Well, this game's not starting out like the Knights drew it up in their head, and sometimes that can mess with you a little bit.
11-0 run, USJ. Roach is 0-for-4 at the foul line. Williamson rebound. Ahead they go quickly to front courts. Floater, no. Madwall rebound. He'll fire a three up. Yes. Well, that's what Aiden Madwall can do, Chuck. He gets hot, and he can fill it up from downtown.
And he's most comfortable at the top of the key just like that. And when he gets that shot, he's going to take it every single time. Got a foul there on Jaylen Brown, a little bit of a push. You bump, but you can't push.
That's trained by Aiden Madwall. Ended an 11-0 run by USJ. Even though it was an 11-0 run, it's still, you look up, it's only a four-point game, but Stan McFarland will shoot the 1+1. USJ, actually now in the double bonus, he'll shoot two.
You know, McFarland, for a big guy, has got a really nice shot. I saw him here on the corner for a three, and that's it's a really nice ball that he's shooting as a free throw right there.
USJ goes 1-2 for the foul line. Not a good night from the charity strike for the Bruins. Williamson, three on its way. Yes. Yeah. He hit that one in stride and knocked the bottom out.
Yeah, he did. I tell you, he felt that one. He knew he had it as soon as it went up.
22-20, just like that. It's a two-point game. The Bruins with the lead and the basketball. Here's Hughes. The defense by Madwall. Hughes gets around him, and the help by Williamson, and then nearly a steal, but off the fingertips of Brown. Great defense by Madwall. Hughes got around him, but Williamson's help defensively nearly ended in a turnover.
Yeah, Jaylen Brown anticipated that pass, jumped the lane, just couldn't control it.
There's Jacob Atkins over to Kobe Hughes. 2 minutes left in the first half. McFarland goes around Barker. but he hooked him when he went around him, an offensive foul, and the Sacred Heart basketball.
Yeah, you don't see those a lot here. And I missed the hook, but that's a big play. They're big turnover in a two-point game with a minute 56 in the first half.
A lot of people on the campus of USJ tonight, the All-Star football game over at the stadium. And here at the gymnasium, it's packed out. Here's Williamson from the elbow. Rises, shoots, misses. Rebound, Colby Hughes for USJ.
I tell you, a lot of shots are just rimming out tonight for both teams, honestly.
Oh, and not a good foul here. Brown 70 feet from the bucket. And that'll send Tanner Atkins to the charity stripe to shoot a pair. This game presented in parts by Outback Steakhouse in Jackson. Chuck, you know, the Ian and Sulaco Company just voted the number one rated Outback Steakhouse in the entire state of Tennessee.
I am not surprised even in the slightest. I don't know anybody who takes their job more serious than Ian. He is phenomenal at it. They have phenomenal service. They are. It's almost perfection every time you go.
It really is. 194 Stonebrook Place in Jackson open at 4 o'clock in the afternoon on weeknights. On the weekend, they open at 11 a.m. on Saturday and Sunday. Tanner Atkins, one of two for the charity stripe. Bruins a three-point lead, and it's a rejection inside. As Roach says, get that out of here. Barker, Harris Barker on the dribble drive. Roach rejected. Sacred Heart keeps the basketball.
Roach is reminding everybody in this gymnasium that it's his post, and if you come down there, you may be met with a SWAT.
Sacred Heart. Oh, beautiful dribble drive and a finish by Marcel. Oh, boy, it's a one-point game just like that. Feels like it's a 10-point USA lead, but you look up, it's a one-point cushion.
Yeah, no, that's a great point, Dan. It hasn't been a ton of back and forth, but Sacred Heart's done just enough to hang around.
And here comes Madwell with a steal. Sacred Heart can take the advantage. Williamson, yes. Oh, boy. Bam, bam, it's a two-point Sacred Heart lead, and listen to that Sacred Heart crowd. Here's Colby Hughes, 46 seconds left. Here's Atkins. Now Hughes, three, no. Rebound taken by Marcel. Sacred Heart off and running. Williamson, three, no, hit the back iron. Barker rebound. Marcel, yes.
Yeah, I tell you what, this pace right here, this is what USJ wants to slow down. They want to control this ball for the half right now because Sacred Heart is more than comfortable playing at this fast pace. USJ did better when they slowed everything down.
27-23. Beautiful pass from Roach. McFarland with the finish. We're seeing some great basketball here tonight.
This is like a playoff atmosphere. You said it earlier. You're 100% right. These teams want it bad.
4 seconds. Williamson. No. What a first half of action here at USJ. Oh, boy. My compliments to the chef. They're feeding us. Me and Chuck are doing it. We're doing that motion. What's his name for the Cowboys running back?
Oh, Ezekiel Elliott. Yeah, yeah.
Keep feeding us.
That's a lot of fun. First half flew by, didn't it?
Entertain us. It really did, Chuck. Entertain us. It's all about us. Thanks to MasterFit Medical Supply. Right here in Jackson, 424-6383. Also, this game is presented by Southeastern Termite Pest Control and Service Company. Get that free home inspection. Tell them what number to call, Chuck.
Anytime, 24-7, even right now, somebody will answer. Get us at 731-660-1052.
By Best One Tire and Service Center of Jackson and of Brownsville. Best One Tire and Service Center and Tennessee Tractor Innovation. That's success through innovation. We're going to talk with USJ basketball coach, the legendary Tony Schutz, the best-dressed coach in West Tennessee. Tony has a Pisani on tonight with a beautiful tie that I bet he picked out himself from Cambridge Limited Men's Clothier. Tony Schutz and Chuck Walker, they're going to have a conversation when we return. At halftime, it's Sacred Heart 27, and USJ 25. We're back here right after this.
It's going down this Thursday at the Blacksmith Bar and Grill. Thursday nights during football season, the Cheap Seats will be live at the Blacksmith for Thursday Night Throwdown. Football fans will have cornhole, ping pong, and we'll be giving away Titans tickets to some lucky winner courtesy of MasterFit Medical. Located at 216 North Shannon Street across from the Farmer's Market. Try the Johnny Cakes or Fried Green Tomatoes or the Molten Burger. Maybe it's the Hot Chicken Sandwich or the Blackened Shrimp. Thursday night's new home for football is the Blacksmith Bar and Grill. Downtown Jackson across from the Farmer's Market. Shop CarLock Nissan of Jackson on-site or online today. CarLock's new and used Nissan dealership in Jackson has stylish, competitively priced new options to explore. So don't put off your search for a Nissan any longer. CarLock's knowledgeable, experienced sales staff is committed to delivering a high quality of service that enables you to shop confidently. At CarLock Nissan of Jackson, we not only believe in supporting our customers, but in supporting the community we're proud to be a part of. We contribute to many causes and organizations, such as the Susan B. Komen Foundation and the Wounded Warrior Project. Slip behind the wheel of a new Nissan Altima for an invigorating test drive or learn about the active safety features that come standard on the Rogue. Visit CarLock Nissan of Jackson today. We have an on-site finance department that will assist you with your bad credit, car loan needs, and a service team that will keep your purchase healthy for many years to come. Don't miss your chance to own a versatile new Nissan Versa today. Visit our dealership on Van Drive in Jackson today.
There's several occasions in life when a man just needs to look good. And at Cambridge Limited Men's Clothier, we understand those moments.
Sally, will you go to the prom with me?
I would, but you look like a hobo.
Do you take this man to be your husband?
Not dressed like that, I won't.
Located on North Highland across from Toys R Us, Cambridge has the best tie selection in town, plus the best price. Size selection 36 short to 54 long and up. We have a tailor on staff and offer law enforcement specials on suits. Cambridge Limited Men's Clothier, North Highland, across from Toys R Us.
You know the temperature in your home? You should. If your system isn't operating properly, you can't stay cool in the steaming summer months that are to come. That's where Garrett Plumbing and Heating Company can help. With years of experience, Garrett services and repairs residential customers. They also provide estimates on new installations. Quality is job one at Garrett. Call 668-3339 and let Garrett Plumbing and Heating and Air go to work for you today.
At Home Medical Products, we provide patients with products to make sure you breathe, sleep, move, and live well. With items like nebulizers, travel oxygen, CPAPs, hospital beds, wheelchairs, scooters, lift chairs, commodes, and so much more. You have a choice when choosing Home Medical Companies. It's the patient's choice. Make the right choice. Locally owned and operated Home Medical Products. Call 877-660-0084 or find them online at hmpinc.net.
All right, everybody, we're back here at USJ. This is Chuck Walker. Taking a second to sit down with a girls' basketball coach, Mr. Tony Schutz. And, Coach Schutz, what a great game we saw. I don't know what your expectations coming in to it were during the girls' game, but it looked like just about everything you drew up, they executed. I know you have to be pleased.
Well, I thought we came out tonight with the right intensity to play a district opponent who are – they were 1-0 in the district, won their first game the other night, and we won ours. So whoever won this game tonight was kind of going to be in the early driver's seat. So I thought our kids did a great job of coming out at the beginning and setting the tempo the way we wanted it.
And that's good, Coach. Tell me a little bit about what you guys were looking – or what you're looking to do this year. I know in high school sports, more so than collegiately and stuff, you know, you can't recruit to your style. So how adaptable for you are you, number one, and with your team this year, what do you see – was there differences from the teams you've had in years past?
Well, the thing is, our first group, most of those girls – I've been playing off and on a little bit some as freshmen. Like Sophie Stallings, a senior, played some as a freshman. Claire Lewis, KK, well, Kaylee Castlegirl, we call her KK. And Emily has been playing since we brought her up as an eighth grader. OJ last year, Olivia Jones, played some as a freshman. So that first core, we can still kind of do what we've done in the past. The thing that we're working at now is trying to work in some sophomores like Julie Wagner, who had a good game tonight. Sarah Beth Browse, Molly Strong. If we can get those three to come in, then we can kind of do some of the things that we did before. We just don't have the depth that we've had in the past couple of years. And plus, we lost Anna Jones 2 years ago, and we lost Ashton Hume last year, Miss Basketball Finals, who's playing really well at Bethel. So we're just trying to find what works for us. Some of the things that we did last year, They don't work anymore, so we just got to kind of find out what works for this group.
Yeah, I know exactly what you're saying there with two losses like that. And how big of a challenge is it? Because this isn't the same depth of a roster that we're used to seeing with USJ. How is you know, time divided out when you're up big late in the game, up by 40, 50 points, as you were during the game? How do you – because, like you said, a lot of your starters are still young. They need that playing time for when the games get tougher down the road. How do you juggle that and then still think about injury and playing time for your bench and everything else?
Well, that's one of the things that we talk about every day, and I'm not an Alabama fan, but I love Nick Saban, and one of the things he always talk about is the process. So we talk about not playing the opponent. Right. We're trying to play to get better. You go out there and work on the things that we work on in practice every day and just try to do that. And that's really hard with young people, especially when you're winning games by maybe 30, 40 points, because they're just looking at the final score, and I'm looking at what you did wrong, and you know, well, coach, no, that won't work against that. So you really have to, like, just pound that in constantly, and they get tired of it. But I think after the early tough schedule that we played, we got their attention, and you can tell they're listening to us more in practice now.
Yeah, it looked like just about everything you dialed up worked perfectly. I will say this, sitting up here watching you, when something didn't work, you still let them know, and I appreciate that. Richard Barber always says that's an opportunity to coach them up, and I like seeing that, because no matter what the score is, you still have the same expectation no matter who's on the floor at the time. Coach, tell us a little bit about what's coming up for the Lady Bruins, the next few games you have. What are you looking at?
Well, we've got a little time off now because of finals next week, so we're giving the girls a few days off. We'll come back Wednesday. Then we have a big game next Saturday night against our crosstown rival, against Trinity. We know they're a quality opponent, so we need to be ready for that. And then after that, we got like a week off before we go to Milan to play in their Christmas tournament. So we just keep working. And as I said, kind of go back to your other question, I don't think, with the younger girls, like when our JV kids go in, no matter what the score, we're trying to coach them up so they can get better, because you never know what injuries, somebody is the next man up or the next girl up, and they got to be ready to go in and help us out. So although we're up, but when we're in those games like that, we're trying to coach those girls so if we ever need them, you know, they can go in and at least know their job. They won't be able to do what Emily or Kaylee or some of the other girls, but they can go in there and put up a good battle for us. So we can still be able to compete.
Well, in that experience, it's the greatest teacher. That's the way Emily and Kaylee and all these other girls got to that point. So, Coach, I can't tell you what a pleasure it was watching you. Good luck in the next few games coming up against Trinity, going to Milan. Good luck to all the girls in their finals, obviously, and we look forward to seeing a lot more from your team, Coach.
Thank you. Thank you. Appreciate it. Nice talking to you.
Yes, sir. You
all
too.
Right.
That was Coach Tony Schutz here. I tell you, you could not ask for a better coach for your women's program around than Tony Schutz. I mean, I tell you, there is so much talent year in and year out at USJ. But what he gets out of these girls and the way that you see them play for him, it's impressive. And, Dan, I know that for a fact there's no bigger fan of Coach Schutz than you. And I know how much he means to this school and how much all the players, you can see it on Anna Ross's face tonight, how much they appreciate him and respect him.
Enjoyed the conversation between you and Tony Schutz at halftime, Chuck.
Thank you, sir. Here we go, third quarter in a game we could not wait to get out of halftime to see.
Boy, you know, they entertained us in the first half. 27-25 Sacred Heart as we start the second half. It was the first half of spurts. It's 4-0 spurt by USJ, 4-0 by Sacred Heart, 11-0 by USJ, and at Sacred Heart on a big spurt to end the first half and take a two-point lead.
Yeah, it really was, and you said it. It felt like USJ controlled it a lot, but they never pulled away. And, you know, I went back and looked at some numbers. It was the free throws, those missed free throws for USJ. Let Sacred Heart hang around enough to take a lead.
Tanner Atkins with a strong offensive rebound. The putback wouldn't go down, but he's fouled. He'll shoot two free throws. You're right, Chuck. The difference in the first half was USJ struggling at the foul line. Well,
yep.
And you got to give Sacred Heart a lot of credit, though. Their defense causing turnovers and converting.
Yeah, no, absolutely. But I tell you what, this kind of game right now, this is what USJ wanted, and this is the exact opposite of what Sacred Heart was looking for. Sacred Heart expected to be up by 10 or 15 points right here with the style that they run.
1 of 2 from the foul line. Tanner Atkins almost got that rebound out of Carum, but it's going to go out of bounds and stay with USA, I believe.
Yeah, if this stays a low-scoring game, if this game ends up in the 40s or 50s, it's going to go a lot towards USA. If this gets to be a 70-point game, it's going to favor Sacred Heart.
Tariq Williams picks up foul number 3. He's back on the bench for Sacred Heart, and the ball will stay with USA. Atkins over on the left wing. Just underway, second half, Dan Reeves along with Chuck Walker, Paul Schulze producing and directing. Text us, let us know where you're watching tonight's game. McFarland went around the rim and came out. Roach had it, lost it, and a tie-up. Possession arrow to Sacred Heart. It was a battle between Tariq Williams and Tanner Atkins.
It's going to be a jump ball. Sacred Heart will keep possession.
There's Sacred Heart. Williamson on top of the key. Checked by Tanner Atkins. Spinning, dishing, in the paint. No. Rebound, Sacred Heart. Stripped away, Colby Hughes. And back by Tariq Williams. Now right wing, Barker, a 3. No. Rebound. And it's another tie-up. Possession arrow this time will send the ball to USJ. Well, they're getting after each other, aren't they?
I tell you what, and Colby Hughes down low does not care about the 8 inches that he gave up right there. He was fighting with Tariq as like if he was a Dikembe Mutombo right there.
The kid's a fighter. He's a battler. He's Colby Hughes.
Just like his daddy and grandpa.
That's right. Here's Dan McFarland. In the paint, floater, yes. Oh, McFarland. And Chuck, you mentioned it. McFarland also has a sweet stroke from downtown. Here's Madwell for 3.
What an answer right there by Sacred Heart.
Aiden Madwell, his second tray. It's a 2-point Sacred Heart advantage, 30-28. Back and forth we go. Here's Roach. And an offensive foul. Roach, he dished it, but he still picks up that foul. He kept his momentum going. And Sacred Heart gets it right back for USA. Jacob Atkins, Colby Hughes, Tanner Atkins. Roach. Stanley Farland under four of the 5 starters for the Bruins.
Yeah, Roach with another rebound, really boxing out well. He's fun to watch when he doesn't have the ball. Both he and McFarland move really well without the ball, getting position.
And look at Williamson with a block of Atkins' shot. Here's Tariq. Now Williamson in the paint. Outside Marcel, a tray. Yes.
I tell you, Sacred Heart starting to heat up from outside, and if they start feeling it, that zone's going to have to come out on the perimeter and guard that. That's going to open up the penetration lanes.
Madwell. And Marcel back-to-back trays for Sacred Heart. McFarland off the glass over Tariq Williams. Dante Williamson bringing it down the floor here for Sacred Heart. DeMadois, 3. Short this time. Rebound Jacob Atkins to Tanner Atkins. Here come the Bruins. Look at that.
What a shot. What a floater.
Oh, boy. Well, I thought we were tied. It's a 1-point game, 33-32. Sacred Heart advantage. Here's Madwell. Oh, the beautiful reverse layup.
And, Dan, I tell you what, I may have been wrong. I didn't think that USJ wanted to play at this fast of a pace, but they're hanging right there blow for blow with Sacred Heart.
Well, the point you made about drawing him out and driving, Madwell proved you right as Jacob Atkins had a 3-pointer go around the rim and come out. Here's Williamson all the way in for 2.
Yeah, this is what Sacred Heart does. Once they get you to bust that zone and go man-to-man, they're so hard to defend. That first move that Williamson has and Marcel has, really all of the starters have a good first step, and it's tough to defend man-to-man. You almost have to stay strong in that zone.
Timeout USJ, and we'll take it with us. 5-point lead for Sacred Heart. We're back in 30 seconds on WNWS.com.
Don't worry, ooh, be happy. This is Tammy Reed telling you not to worry when it comes to real estate. Turn it over to the number one real estate team in West Tennessee. We will take all the worries out of your real estate experience. No gimmicks, no unkept promises, just happy clients. Call the Reed Nelson team, Hickman Realty Group, 664-1006. Don't worry, be happy.
4 minutes and 14 seconds left. Quarter number three, 37-32. Sacred Heart with the advantage over USJ. My name's Dan Reeves along with Chuck Walker, Paul Schulze, Worthy Road Studios. Pleasure to have you along with us here at the University School of Jackson. What a game so far. 5-point lead, Sacred Heart. Sacred Heart, two trays in the third quarter. They've taken the advantage. 5-point lead.
Yeah, this fast pace that they play, but USJ's hung with them right here. This is going to be a really big possession for USJ. Looks like they're going to slow it down a little bit, pass the ball around.
Wesley Carlock, another dribble drive. He worked at baseline. It's his fourth point tonight. Both his shots came same off that dribble drive at a baseline. And Roach with a rebound. He's fouled by Tariq Williams.
Another offensive rebound by Roach, and I tell you, that's Tariq's third foul. In fourth quarter, you get three, four fouls. You got to come out, and once that happens, Sacred Heart, who's already losing the rebound battle, that'll be even tougher for him.
Nathan Malik back in the game to 6-11. Malik looking mad while steal to Williamson. No, good defense by Roach again. It's out of bounds, and it'll stay with Sacred Heart.
You know, I don't like that by Williams. I don't like that shot there. I think you got to set your feet, go up, maybe draw the foul. He rushed it just a little bit. That's why that shot never had a chance.
Here's Williamson right wing. Now Malik, the turnaround in the paint, yes. Boy, if they could get something from Malik, oh boy.
I tell you, his shot has gotten so much better just since a year ago. That softer touch, he's really tough to defend down. There's only so many human beings that are 6'11".
Wesley Carlock all the way in off the, well, I said off the floater. Wesley Carlock, 6 points tonight. Here's Magwa, step back three, yes.
I tell you, somebody forgot to tell the Bruins they were an underdog in this game. They're going blow to blow, toe to toe right now, 6-point game.
Here's a foul on, they got to call a charge, wow. I don't know how you call a charge on that, but they did. That's number three on Taylor Atkins.
Yeah, third foul. Boy, I tell you, that's big for USJ. Sacred Heart's got a lot of guys in foul trouble, but Tanner Atkins is probably the last guy you want to lose right now if you're USJ.
3:05 left. Third quarter, 42-36, Sacred Hearts. And Coach Hudson does not substitute very often. Malik, no. Rebound. Oh, there's a foul on Malik, but they didn't call it. It's out of bounds to USJ. As Wesley Carlock getting some extended playing time. He's been a real spark plug off the bench tonight for the Bruins. He can handle the ball well, and he can certainly score the ball. Now in trouble in the backcourt. He's fouled. As Carlock dribbled himself out of trouble.
Yeah, they had him trapped on the sideline there. Coach Beauregard's really wanting to, you know, double down on that. It's really tough to do anything with it. Carlock was able to dribble out.
That's the third team foul on Sacred Heart here in the second half. USA has two of those babies. Here's Wesley. It's been full court pressure causing trouble tonight for the Bruins. Yeah. Here's McFarland right wing.
Yeah, Sacred Heart stay with that man even on the inbounds.
McFarland step back three, yes. Stan McFarland, it's a three-point game.
He's got a nice touch for a big man. He can post up, he can rebound, he can shoot. It's really tough to defend.
Magwa, no. Carlock got a hand on it. Tanner Atkins comes away with the rebound. Let us know where you want you tonight. Text us. 731-277-5155. Let us know where you're watching tonight's action. Here's Wesley Carlock in the right wing against Barker. Teammates last year, not this year. Now Tanner Atkins in the foul line. Had it away, taken by Sacred Heart.
Yeah, Williamson on the tip there, able to get possession back to Sacred Heart.
Barker three, no. Rebound, Tanner Atkins.
You know, Barker hadn't had a touch tonight. He's been a really high, like a 45-50% three-point shooter coming into tonight. I don't know that he's had one drop yet.
Stan McFarland working in the paint.
Williamson, how many is that on here?
That's three that I've got. Unless I've missed one, that's three for Williamson. I tell you, he's their scorer. He's their spark plug. He keeps this offense going. They get in trouble. This game gets close. He's what opens it back up. You don't want that.
Must have got him with a body. Looked like he got a lot of ball. Falling, it's the first. The USA struggled tonight from the foul line as Wesley Carlock gets a breather, and Jacob Adkins comes back into the game for the Bruins.
Yeah, you know, if McFarland's going to bang in the post like that and shoot free throws as well, that's who I'm going to work this ball through the entire rest of this game if I'm the Bruins.
And hit free throws, hits them both. It's a one-point game, 42-41 Sacred Hearts. Minute 24 left, third quarter. Here's Malik, now Madwalk, driving the baseline all the way in, the reverse, yes! Look at Aiden Madwalk.
What an unbelievable first layup right there. I tell you what, I know you practice that, but you don't see that a lot.
And Madwalk voguing. Here's Roach, goes around Malik for two. Now Malik didn't move his feet, and Roach went right around it.
Got a one-point game here. USJ is just not slowing down.
Madwalk, no. And a foul on Malik coming over Roach. Team foul number six.
Yeah, that's Malik's second. And that's the right call there. I know Sacred Heart's a little upset about it, but he's moving. He's a big guy. That's an over-the-back foul. That's the right call, I'm afraid, in that situation.
Well, this region's tough. Sacred Heart, USA. His teams from Memphis.
Yeah, FACS just had a comeback win against Sacred Heart in overtime on Tuesday of this week. They're somebody to deal with. ECS is always good.
Yep. And you add in the other region here on the west side.
Yeah, St. George and everybody else.
Yep. Lausanne.
Yeah. Just a little team called Lausanne.
Tough to make a living in this region. Well, that's the 16th foul. Right?
Oh, boy. You know, I thought that may have been a little bit of a push there for the Bruins on Atkins. I'm not sure exactly what he saw there.
Here's Tanner Atkins. No, he missed it down low. 12 seconds left. Here's Williamson. And the paint all the way in. No. Malik with a foul over the back. And with 6 seconds left, in the corner, we're going to walk the floor and shoot the one plus one. Oh, boy.
Man, that's a tough foul on Malik there. Two tough fouls from Sacred Heart here in just a span of 10 seconds. I mean, as the quarter was winding down.
Well, you know, Hamilton Hudson, his substitution pattern is not a pattern. So you'll see some of the, like Tanner Atkins, you can see he's winded like now. And last year, Oliver Simmons, who's here tonight, the former head coach, who's at Haywood County these days, substituted freely, but Hudson, he goes all the way. Roach misses. Here's Williamson with 4 seconds. 3 seconds. Marcel at the buzzer. Yes.
That three is good, Kevin Marcel. What a perfect pass by Williamson to leave him alone in the corner right there. That may be the biggest shot of the game right now. Going in up four to the fourth quarter versus one is huge for Sacred Heart.
47-43, Sacred Heart after three on WNWS.com.
Legal problems don't always arise Monday through Friday, 8 to 5. When you need an attorney, you need them now. This is Bradley Owens of Hardy Martin & Owens Law Firm. Add my cell number to your contacts, 234-2400. That's 234-2400. At Hardy Martin & Owens, we handle all types of legal problems, including personal injury, workers' compensation, divorce and family law, estates, and criminal defense. With offices in Jackson and Trenton, let Hardy Martin & Owens handle all your legal needs. 424-2151 or on my cell, 234-2400.
Tipping the scales in your favor.
Here we go, buckle up. Off to the fourth quarter, what a game we've had so far. We've had 7 lead changes, 4 ties. And as we begin the fourth quarter, Sacred Heart has the basketball. and a four-point advantage. My name's Dan Reeves, along with Chuck Walker, Paul Schulze, Worthy Road Studios, here at USJ. What a game.
It's been an unbelievable game. You know, normally they let the press in free here for us to do this game. I may go buy a ticket. It's been so good.
Feel like we should. We've been entertained. Entertain us. Is Williamson fouled by Atkins. 33 in the bucket. That's team foul number three on the Bruins. USJ's in the bonus the rest of the game. 7:42 left. We just started the fourth quarter.
Foul call on number two, Jacob Atkins.
That's personal foul number one on Jacob Atkins. Oh, and Marcel nearly lost it.
Boy,
he did. Medwall runs it down. Here's Marcel again. And a foul on Tanner Atkins. That's going to be number four, I believe.
Yeah, that is four there. That's the right call. That was the design play. Almost like a little alley-oop layup there to Jaylen Brown. They'd worked that out. Atkinson, he doesn't want to pick up his fourth foul, but that's the only thing he can do right there to stop two from going in.
Well, USA could ill afford to lose Tanner Atkins. Playing with four fouls. 7:20 left in the game. 47 for Sacred Heart, 43 for USJ. And Sacred Heart trying to draw the Bruins out of the zone, just going to hold the basketball. Williamson out near the timeline.
Yeah, you see this in high school basketball sometime. That's why I think you really need to institute a shot clock. I know in some states like Texas and a couple others, it's already there. I'd love to see that in high school basketball.
There's no reason not to have one, Chuck. You're right. Now Sacred Heart all the way in. Yes! Jaylen Brown with the finish.
That's a technical on Brown. I don't know what happened after that shot, but that's a technical. It's going to take USJ to the line there.
Well, Brown was he was excited. It was a beautiful offensive set, and he flexed, and he got teed up.
Yeah.
A little bit too close to a Bruin, I guess, and Stan McFarland, eagle-eye foul shooter. Hits them both. Brown, instead of a 49-43 lead, and the momentum. That shot was offset with two foul shots, and the Bruins get the ball back and a chance at a five-point trip.
I tell you, they're just not going away. And the refs, I mean,
it went around the rim and out, and a foul on Roach coming over the back of Brown going after that rebound. Well, that was a big – that ball by Kobe Hughes went around the rim and came out.
Yeah, they could have made it a one-point game. And I tell you, the refs, we're not the only people here that could feel this electricity and this intensity. They're doing everything they can to let this game decide it out. They're not going to let emotion go or anything get away from them here.
Packed house here with USA. What a crowd tonight for these guys. Here's Madwalk. He's been red hot here in the second half. Timeouts. Sacred Heart will take the timeout with him with 6:18 left. What a game here tonight. University School of Jackson, it's 49-45, Sacred Heart with a four-point lead on WNWS.com.
Welcome to Hughes Eye. Our doctors and staff look forward to having you as a patient at our clinic. Our doctors and staff work together as a team to treat patients with outstanding care in a positive and friendly environment. We work closely with your local eye and medical doctors to provide care centered around you. Hughes Eye has offices throughout West Tennessee to better serve you. We offer cataract, LASIK, and glaucoma procedures, retina and oculoplastic specialties, as well as the treatment and management of many ocular diseases. We're proud to offer advanced technology to provide the most up-to-date treatment options for your eyes. Prior to your appointment, please take a moment to visit our website at HughesEye.com. There, you can submit new patient forms, find directions to our clinics, and learn more about your ocular condition.
The Hughes Eye Group, 112 Stonebridge, Jackson. The best in medical and surgical eye care. Call 731-664-1994 and visit HughesEye.com.
6:06 left in the game. Here's Sacred Heart in the lane. A floater, yes!
Good ball movement there by Sacred Heart to find Marcel open. They kicked it around both wings before Marcel's finally at the top of the key just to floater down the lane.
Sacred Heart with a six-point advantage. 5:47 left. Kobe Hughes. McFarland. Yes.
McFarland will not let this Bruin team go away. He is putting them on his back.
Stan McFarland from downtown. It's a three-point game. McFarland is red hot, leading the Bruins tonight. Here's Marcel off of the Williamson. Williamson at hang time, no. Madwall, no. And a foul on Ruck. Now that's one that may have been just
That may be a call to get it back from earlier, possibly.
But again, I must say, there's a reason why they don't put the officials in our position up here to call the game. They got a much better vantage point.
That's true, but Roach looks set there, but who knows?
Look, maybe a no call. Both those guys were battling down low, but who knows what happened. 5 minutes left in the game. Here's Williamson. In that paint again, beautiful dish, and a travel. Oh boy, that was a gorgeous dish, and Tariq Williams shuffled the feet after the help came over defensively, but Williamson, just a gorgeous no-look pass.
Yeah, and you said it earlier about not on the leak, and you're right too. When you're a big guy and you get that ball down low, you see that travel so often.
As USJ down by three. Roach, floater, no. Madwall, good defense and the rebound for Madwall. Sacred Heart has led this entire second half.
Yeah, they really have. USJ's got it within one a couple of times, but Sacred Heart, you know, every time something would happen, they were able to keep the lead with a foul or a turnover.
Oh, boy, Tanner Atkins just fouled out. Oh, boy. Tanner's such a competitor.
You can't, with four on you, you can't get, that can't be how you end the game right there. Can't be how you foul out. That's tough.
But you know, you got to some point, when you get in foul trouble, you got to set. And no criticism on Hamilton Hudson. He's obviously proves it in putting with his product. That's a lot of time on the floor with only five fouls to give up. And Marcel hits the first. Gets the back in, 53-48 into replace. Tanner Atkins is Wesley Carlock. The silver lining is Wesley's played well tonight, but they give up quite a bit of height to the Bruins. And Madwall steal.
Got two on one.
Madwall. What a game tonight for Aiden Madwall.
I can tell you something about Aiden. He plays a lot bigger than 5'8". He's had that reverse layup. He's had this, you know, drive down there. He floats that ball up high. This is a big and one opportunity right here for the Knights.
Well, he missed it. Rebound caroms out of bounds off of USJ. Timeouts, USJ. We'll take the timeout with him. 4:13 left. It's a 7-point Bulls for Sacred Heart on WNWS.com.
Once again, Marco's Pizza is the spot for Monday Night Football. The cheap seats will be live on the road at Marco's Pizza, 1146 Van Drive. Come join us for amazing Marco's Pizza, wings, subs, and so much more while we get you ready for the big game. Call 300-0400 for delivery or carryout, and don't forget you can order online at Marco's.com. A match made in heaven. The cheap seats, Monday Night Football, and Marco's Pizza. Truly authentic.
Fourth 13 left in the fourth quarter. 55-48 advantage. Sacred Hearts. This game presented by Sonic of Jackson with six Jackson locations. Also by Hardy. Martin and Owens, attorneys at law, they tip the scale in your favor. The heavy hitters, 424-2151. My attorney wears suits and eats them up like catfish, 424-2151. Hardy, Martin and Owens. Dan Reeves and Chuck Walker with you, along with Paul Schulze. Oh, this is a foul on Sacred Hearts. Kendrick Beard, a hustle foul, though. He ain't gonna let that pass get in there. 4 minutes and 3 seconds left. We're in the fourth quarter. And Sacred Heart putting some distance between themselves and USJ, matching the largest lead of the game. 7-point lead Atkins can do something about it from the charity stripe. First one is good. Now, those, all those missed free throws by USA in the first half, Chuck. If this score holds, they're going to look back on it and say, geez.
That's exactly where it was. And that allowed Sacred Heart to stay alive in the first half. You know, this is a tale of two different halves. USA controlled the majority of the first half everywhere except for the scoreboard right at the last tick.
Had an 11-0 run, had a nearly a double-digit lead there. But Sacred Heart went on a spurt just before the half to take a halftime advantage. One of two from the foul line for Jacob Atkins. Six-point lead. Sacred Heart, 3:38 left in a two-possession game. Here's Marcel, the floater, yes! I mean, he was off balance and threw it up, and it went nothing but net.
Yeah, and Wesley Carlock came up limping a little bit there. He's having to stretch out to get back right again. I think they landed on one another.
Jacob Atkins way downtown. That ill-advised shot won't go. Sacred Heights in control. Timeouts. Sacred Heights had him trapped. And Boyguard calls a T.O.
Yeah, that's a smart timeout right there. Javion was trying to do something with it, but when you get double-teamed, that's what Beauregard was trying to have him do, I believe, Atkins down there in the third quarter when he was able to dribble out of it. You get two of them on and you're locked down like that, there's nowhere to go. That's usually a turnover.
3:08 left in the game. 8-point lead. Sacred Heart, that's the largest of the game, Chuck.
I tell you, with 3 minutes left, what a game it's been. So much back and forth. And I tell you, USJ's found a way to stay in it up to this point.
Call like Nissan of Jackson bringing you this basketball game on Van Drive. Call like Nissan of Jackson.com. Out of the dish by Williamson and the finish by Brown.
Really nice play.
10-point lead. That's going to be really tough for the Bruins to overcome this deficit.
Well, you know, Sacred Hearts wanted to get the penetration all night, and they weren't able to. They stayed at it. They drew them out of the zone a little bit. That's opened up those lanes a little bit, and they're so tough when they're able to penetrate.
Big rebound by Carlock. Wesley. Oh, it went around the rim and came out on him. Williamson with another rebound. And he's fouled. They'll shoot two.
Yeah, getting to the lane, getting the line. 2 minutes left, 10 points, two free throws coming up. It's going to be tough for the Bruins, but what a game we've had so far.
Sacred Heart unwilling to relinquish control here in the second half. You got to really hand it to them.
Yeah, you know, I really, really like Coach Hudson's plan coming into this game. That zone defense gave them a lot of trouble in the first half, and I tell you, they were able to run with Sacred Heart. Sacred Heart runs one of the fastest paced offenses that I've seen in high school in a long time, and USJ was not intimidated by it, didn't slow it down, and really held to a lot of assignments in the first half.
Williamson goes 1-of-2 for the foul line. 60-49, Sacred Heart by 11, largest lead by either team. On Madlaw fouls Hughes. So any time that USA could get that clock stopped and score. But the bottom is, Chuck, the struggles tonight from the charity strike from these Bruins.
Yeah, that's exactly right. That's, you know, I'd be interested to go back and look at the numbers and see what it was in the first half. But there was a lot that just weren't falling. I know Kobe Roach was 0-for-4 in the first half at least.
Kobe Hughes, free throw good. Game presented in part by Ace Hardware of Jackson. Those great December specials at Ace Hardware, 3315 North Highway. Hughes hits them both. It's a 9-point deficit for the Bruins, 60-51. 2 minutes left in the game. USA, no fouls to give. Madwab is second line content to run clock. The clock is the ally. Foul on Jacob Atkins.
Yeah. Now,
you know, Atkins slapped it away from Marcel, but Marcel did a smart thing. He still used his body to keep separation between the ball and the defender and able to draw the foul.
And that's what you got to do there. And I tell you, Marcel stays so low to the ground. His dribble is so low. It's really tough to take away without slapping a hand or something like that.
Yep. Double bomb is time for Sacred Heart. This game presented in part by the Hughes Eye Group. They're in Jackson, cataract, LASIK, retina, glaucoma, oculoplastic.
Lane violation there, Sacred Heart.
The best in medical and surgical eye care. 112 Stonebridge, Jackson, 664-1994. Visit HughesEye.com. Y'all wipe that free throw away. Dolby Hughes with a teardrop floater timeout. USJ will take that timeout with him. A minute 34 left. The Bruins still alive. A heartbeat down by eight on Jackson. Well on WNWS.com.
MasterFit Medical Equipment is on a mission, and that mission is to serve everyone with premium medical equipment at savings you wouldn't find elsewhere. At MasterFit, we represent over 200 medical equipment and supply manufacturers and over 90,000 products, with much of it in our warehouse right here in Jackson. Defibrillators, monitors, EKGs, pumps, sensors, and more. So when you need more affordable medical equipment, call MasterFit Medical Equipment at 554-1223.
Minute 34 left in the game. Sacred Heart with a 61-53 lead over USJ. Dan Reeves along with Chuck Walker. Chuck, where does Sacred Heart play their home games?
Well, you know, it's kind of crazy. It depends on how big of a crowd they're expecting. They play some games at North Parkway Middle School, some games at the Omen Arena. Last Friday, they played Trinity Christian Academy at the Omen Arena. You know, you remember last year, Dan, the USJ game was at Omen Arena, so that's a lot of fun for the kids. But they're looking by the late spring, early summer to have the gymnasium finished. They're building a brand new state-of-the-art gymnasium there at Sacred Heart where they can house home games next year.
Are they hoping to get, I guess it would be a little late for this season, but next year?
Yeah, I think initially anticipated that was the hope to maybe get a handful of games there this year, but just weather and extenuating circumstances I don't believe are going to allow it.
Williamson at the foul line, misses the first. Both teams in a double bonus with 10 plus fouls. Tanner Ackers is fouled out for USA. Williamson goes 1 of 2, 62-53 Sacred Hearts. Wesley Carlock with a quick two. USA going to have to get a steal. Just missed getting a steal there.
Man, that was so close. Two shots there. I didn't see where the foul was. I actually thought that was a kick ball at first.
Sean Jacob Atkins, his fourth. And Marcel making him pay at the foul line. Rock and Roll Pizza also bringing you USJ Bruins basketball. Marcel hits them both.
Yeah, two big free throws right there.
And Madwa steal. Aiden Madwa. That's going to do it.
Yeah, I think so right now. It's going to be real, real tough. 55 ticks on the clock. Come back in it. You got Javion Greer shooting these two here. He's a money clutch free throw guy.
What Aiden Madwa, what a game tonight here against USA. Last time he'll play on this floor. Javion Greer, a lot of pressure put on him by Chuck.
I'm telling you, this is the first time I think I may have seen him miss.
Missed him twice.
Somebody check that ball. Make sure it's not up long.
Tom Brady might be handling it. McFarland, oh! Nearly a chance at a four-point play.
Yeah, still three free throws. That's a tough foul there. You know, this score doesn't reflect right now how close this game has been. This has been a very, very highly contested game. Both sides back and forth. really, really a lot of great action. Here at the end, it's kind of slipped away a little bit. A couple of tough calls, a couple of, you know, balls go through the hoop, but it's really been a wonderful game to watch.
You can see the Bruins kind of all the air came out of the balloon when Tanner Atkins fouled out.
Yeah, it's tough. It's tough. He's doing a lot for this team.
And the Bruins have only used six players tonight, which is not unusual this season. Both free throws missed, and there's the other key component. Missed free throws for the Bruins, and Sacred Heart taking advantage.
Yeah, I bet I know what a lot of the practice time is going to look like next week for the Bruins.
Steal by Wesley Clark. Oh, boy. What an athlete he is.
And he gets the and-one shot here, refusing to go away. That's going to keep him. If he hits this, keeps him within six. That's two possessions with 30 seconds left. That's a lot of time left in the game. It's not over yet.
And that's 3 points. Shot went down by McFarland. And that free throw could be a two-point game. Three-point play the old-fashioned way. Wesley Carlisle. Timeout Bruins. Yeah, it's not over yet with 30 seconds left in the game. 64-58. Sacred Heart. We're back in 30 seconds on WNWS.com.
Overton Flooring Hardwood Sales and Refinishing in Bells, Tennessee is ready to take your home to the next level with beautiful hardwood flooring selections from hickory, maple, heart of pine, acacia, and distressed oak. At Overton Flooring, we have the only showroom featuring sanded, stained, and finished flooring. If you're ready for a beautiful new look for your home, call the floor guy, Al Overton, at 345. That's 345-3114. Overton Flooring, 12808 Highway 79 in Bells. Open Monday through Friday.
30 seconds left in the game, 64-58. It's still a two-possession game, and USJ's got a foul. They're just laying back. Finally, Roach fouls Javion Greer, who just missed two free throws. We'll see. And normally a very good free throw shooter.
Yeah, it really is. Just had that second one just kind of roll out. It was harder to miss than it was to hit the way it was flying in there.
Oh, that would be. Look bad coming off the fingertips. He's missed three straight.
And, you know, that's a lot of pressure for a sophomore. Javion's just a sophomore here, and maybe the noise and the intensity is getting to him a little bit.
Oh, he missed him and got the rebound. Wow.
That's the one thing that can't happen. And, man, what have we talked about? Kobe Roach being all over the boards all night long, and I think he thought Carlock was going to get it, so he let it go.
Yep. And that's been really the story of the game. Sacred Heart getting those loose balls.
That's 0 for 5 now. I put the jinx on. I'd like to apologize to Javion's family.
You know, 8 seconds have come off the scoreboard during this transaction, however. Timeout. Sacred Heart, we will take it with them. 22 seconds left. 6-point lead, Sacred Heart on WNWS.com.
This weekend at Old Town Spaghetti Store, enjoy blackened catfish with shrimp over grits, a blackened catfish fillet and shrimp served with garlic cheese grits, and your choice of house salad or soup, the fresh catch Atlantic salmon, and the soup, creamy chicken and vegetable, and the best prime rib in town, slow roasted and cut to order, tender, juicy, and full of flavor. Happy hour Monday through Friday, 5 to 8 p.m. with half-price drinks. Old Town Spaghetti Store gift certificates make great stocking stuffers. For every $100, get $20 free. Old Town Spaghetti Store, Caritas Drive, Jackson.
USA still alive, but just barely. And surprisingly enough, Javion Greer, who's a solid free throw shooter, has missed 5 straight. He'll have one more.
This is huge here. This takes it from 2 possessions to 3. Biggest shot of the game.
Got it.
Yeah. 7-point game now.
It's Carlock, stolen by Madwar. Madwar fouled. He'll shoot 2 free throws, and that's going to be the final nails in the Bruins' coffin tonight. As Sacred Hearts come in here, big crowd, raucous crowd. USJ led most of the first half.
Shakenai went on a spurt just before halftime to take a two-point lead to the locker room. But Chuck Shakenai took control early in the third, and they've not looked back.
Yeah, they really have. You know, the game, a couple of shots started falling for them. I think USJ broke that zone a little bit. The lanes were opening up. And, you know, with a game like this, a relatively low-scoring game for Sacred Heart, 8 or 9 points with the defense they've been able to play tonight just made it too tough for the Bruins to come back. And those missed free throw opportunities have really come back to haunt USJ.
Jacob Atkins fouls out. Nicholas Corley replaces. Both free throws are good by Nadwar. 67-58, Sacred Hearts. This Carlott, Colby Hughes, McFarlane, yes.
Nice pass there.
And a foul to walk the floor and shoot two. Nicholas Corley, son of Jared. His brother played so well here at USJ football. And last year, he also played tremendous for the Bruins in basketball. Decided not to play basketball last year, focused on football. Nine-point lead. 4 seconds left. Here's Carlott.
That's a big win there. That draws both teams to 1-1 in the district, but feels different. Even though it's the same record right now, it feels different. I can't say how great of a game that was to watch. Two teams really went at it for four quarters. You don't always see that in high school basketball, but it started off like a playoff atmosphere, and I feel like it ended like one.
Well, Sacred Heart came in 3-4, but they lost a 6-point game at Bolivar, dropped a close game to Humboldt, 78-72, lost by three down at Cork, Mississippi. Lost by three to FACS. So a tough early season schedule for Sacred Heart. A little misleading with that record coming in, Chuck.
Yeah, it was, and I think that's what Coach Beauregard wanted. He wanted to test them early and often. He knew what this district was. He knew what this district had in it. And with the senior-laden team that he has, I think he really wanted to test them as early as he could, and he did. But, you know, kudos to USJ in this game for coming out with the intensity that they had and the game plan that they had. And this was such a tight game, such a close game for so long.
USJ loses for the second time this year. The Bruins dropped to 5-2 overall. And this evens their record at 1-1 in the region. USJ next Saturday night. Trinity, that's our next broadcast. Next Saturday night versus Trinity Christian Academy. For Sacred Hearts, their worksheets, they got Liberty Tuesday night and Crusaders.
Yeah, I tell you, both teams left it out there right now. For USJ, it's just a story of the free throws, things not going their way. For Sacred Heart, I think it's got to be, what do you do when it's not working for you that first half? How do you adjust? I know they stayed with their game plan and ended up working out, but what USJ did that first half really held a high-scoring team down low. You saw what Sacred Heart wanted to do, especially in that fourth quarter. That's the style that they want to run. So I look for both teams to have a good season in what I still think is one of the toughest districts in all of Tennessee, all regions of all of Tennessee.
I totally agree with you, Chuck. Great basketball being played in this region. This game brought to you by Sonic of Jackson with 6 Jackson locations. By the Hughes Eye Group, the best in medical and surgical eye care. By Outback Steakhouse, the number one Outback Steakhouse restaurant in the state of Tennessee. By Carlock Nissan of Jackson. By Southeastern Termite Pest Control and Service Company. Sarah of Jackson. Rock and Roll Pizza. Home Pros Restoration. By King Jewelers. Garrett Plumbing, Heating and Air Conditioning. Home Medical Products, HMPinc.net. By Sakura Japanese Restaurants. By Young Hughes Insurance. Marco's Authentic Italian Pizza on Van Drive. Massive Hit Medical Supply, along with Premier Dental Center and Jackson Bells and MylandPrimDent.com. By the Hickman Realty Group, Norm and Tammy Reed. By Vein and Vascular Center of Jackson. That's one tower in service of Jackson and Brownsville. By Tennessee Tractor. Snappy Tomato Pizza on Van Drive. By the Old Town Spaghetti Store. By Young Hughes Insurance. Also by Hardy, Martin, and Owens, attorneys at law. My attorneys wear suits and eat them up like catfish. Will Walker, great job in the first game. Chuck, fantastic job here in the second game. We really enjoyed it.
Man, I really appreciate you having me. It's a lot of fun for both of us. Both Walkers, appreciate you guys.
Man, we had fun tonight with the Walker boys. The Walker brothers, right again. For Paul Schulze, Chuck Walker, for Will Walker, for Drew Magruder, as USGA, the girls win big, and the Sacred Heart boys win the nightcap. We'll say goodnight from USJ. Tomorrow morning, Coach Joe and I will be at Cambridge Limited Men's Clothier with the Bud Light Sports Zone. Join us there. Great deals for Christmas at 2150 North Highland Avenue. My name's Dan Reeves. Thank you for listening. Or thank you for watching USJ Bruin Basketball. Good night. We'll talk with you tomorrow morning.
Anytime. I had so much fun. That's the first basketball game I've ever done. That was great.
Are you serious?
Swear to God, the first one I ever done.